This is an after-action report for Flashpoint Campaigns Red Storm. Today's scenario is Hell's Crossroads. Here's the overall description. I'm in command of the Soviet forces, while my opponent is command of the UK forces. Here are our general orders. Victory is approximately over two-thirds, so I need to get at least two-thirds of the victory points in order to win. We'll take a quick look at the victory points and see that we start off with just under 14 and a half, and the enemy has 9. So we have approximately 50% more power, killing power, or victory point than he does. There are 9,000 victory points, so two-thirds would be 6,000. And we'll probably need 7,000 to be certain of a marginal victory. These are my starting locations. I've got a lot of tanks, 125th Tank Regiment and the 143rd Guard, battalion, 143rd Guards Infantry, 111th Guards Tank Battalion, and the two. My strategy will be, I need about 7,000 points. So here are the victory point locations. There's 9. So I need to grab and hold on to 7 of them. Of course, the big one's going to be the 3,000 one. So we have to, that's a must, because all the other ones, that's only 6,000 combined. So we have to at least take this one plus a number of others. So you need 3. It looks like I'm going to try to take 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe even 8. But I'm generally going to try to take 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Those are or 7 here. So this area is what I'm going to try. Everything else is, I'll consider gravy. My strategy, I have a number of starting areas. I've looked at the map, and every time I play this, I've played this a number of times in multiplayer and solitaire already. I approach every scenario as though I don't know anything. That's the only way to keep it fair with my opponent. We have 3 starting areas. I'm just making decisions according to what I see on the map and the victory locations and my overall strategy plan. In the south, I don't see any point starting out here. There's nothing, there's nowhere to go. You're blocked off by a lake here, and you're heading up this way, so I don't see the use of that starting location whatsoever. I'm taking a little bit of a gamble. What I'm going to do is I am going to gather these are all my forces. This is the entire, I guess, the battle group, and I'm going to be assembling them up in this Emsburen area, city of Emsburen. I will refit, rearm, reload, and get everything ready. My intention will be, once I come, I'm going to be sweeping down through here and across and back. So if I can grab all these and then end up here, whether or not I grab this one or this one in the end is minor. They're small amounts. In the south, I'm using my anti-tank forces. These are my self-propelled anti-tank platoons. I've got 3 or 4 of them, and I order them to take an area to the south because it's close. I don't know how close the enemy is, but I'm expecting him not to be set up right in front on my doorstep. At least I'm hoping so. Nonetheless, my self-propelled anti-tank are heading off on deliberate movement mode, and we'll take a quick look. We'll try to hold a few of these high areas here. I'm going to try to blow this bridge, and I've got one more right in the middle here. Going to hold up here. These are really cheap forces. If we take a look at them, there's 12 victory points, and the anti-tank one are only worth 7 points each. So each unit here, really, that's worth a total of 28 points. That's not even the price of an enemy armored personnel carrier. See, we'll take a look at his, that's one of his recon tanks, or pretty much any one of his vehicles, 24 inch. So in for this reason, see, notice his main battle tanks and his scimitars and his tracked vehicles. Well, his eight armored personnel carriers aren't worth very much either. What I'm trying to do is, if he comes, I'm using these are my disposable throwaway forces. This is if the enemy approaches, if he approaches, if I can even get a single one of his tanks or armored personnel carriers and lose the entire unit, and lose the entire company, in fact. If I lose the entire company, that would be pretty much equal to one of his tanks. That's a bargain. So if any of these anti-tank forces score on the enemy, I'm ahead of the game, or at least I won't be behind. I have set the reconnaissance battalion here, or company. I have some of them up, and I am ordering them to blow bridges. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to seal off an area here. It's not really important, but I want to give the enemy the impression that this is where my activity is. I'm trying to protect this area. I want him, keeping him in this mind, I want him to see bridges going down, and I want him to see this victory point location changing hands, so he'll know that there's something here, but he's going to have to come in to find out what is happening here. The more bridges I blow down, the more I will be showing the enemy, yeah, something's here. I want to give him the impression that I'm trying to protect something. Maybe my artillery is here, or my headquarters, or something else. So to that end, I've had a couple of surface-to-air missile units starting from this area. The reason why I have them here is because they have this radar. They have an air search radar, and you can't turn it off. So it's on all the time. There. So the enemy will counter-detect us. However, hopefully he won't see exactly what's here. You'll just see a blip, his radar blip. So by him seeing these two, I'm hoping he's thinking I'm using the SAMs for their range. This is their SAM range. And this is the SAM range. So I'm hoping he's thinking that I'm using the SAMs to protect a vital area in the south. I've got an armored car coming out to hold this point. This is pretty empty or flat area. The visibility is only 1500, but it probably going to go up. In my experience, it's gone up quite high. So if we can hold this area from this one, we'll use a control, we shift, click, and we'll see that this is generally the area that you can see. Personally, anything under 50 is probably going to be hidden from me, or I'm not expecting to see anything under the 50 value. So this outer range is probably not going to be spotted, but I'm trying to keep an eye on the road as it approaches. Once I blow the bridge, I'm going to retreat up one level to these three, elevation three, and try to keep a watch on this area. I've got a helicopter going out. I'm going to do a quick sweep of the south. I have to be very careful with helicopters in the face of surface-to-air missiles. They're quite potent, and these are my eyes. So I don't want to have the enemy poking me out. I don't want to risk them too far into enemy territory, but I figured this is somewhat neutral and relatively safe enough. In the north, I've massed all my forces. We're going to assemble in this area. I have them all approaching on different paths. Some of them are delayed so that we don't have to have too many traffic jams around here. Just by a couple of minutes to let the ones in front go. Oh, my SAM units, because I'll show the waypoint. The first decision cycle is 29-27 minutes. That means the enemy won't, when he detects me within his first 29 minutes, he won't be able to actually fire anything until the 29th minute, when he gets his decision cycle back. For this reason, I have given my SAM units a delay of 20 minutes, so they're going to sit here for 20 minutes and not start moving until the 20th minute. The reason I'm doing this, I want him to get a good look, but then I'm not going to sit here and just let him blast me, because that's just what happens when SAM units stop. The radar stays on and you die very quickly. So these units will only survive as long as they're on the move, and even then, the enemy can catch me. He can predict where I might be heading and lay down his artillery barrage and probably and catch me. But it's going to cost him a lot of artillery missions to do so, and it may not be worth it. Keeps him busy, and every mission he fires against a moving target is one less he fires against a stationary or a valuable target. My SAMs are very important, but they're very cheap in the terms of victory points. There's 4 points, and this one's a little bit more expensive, 11, but they do protect me from his air. In the north, I have my helicopter. I'm going to do a quick sweep. This is a very high, I guess, a ridge. It's probably the dominant geographical feature all through, and I'm just going to go up and peek over it, and then scout through the middle and land here to rearm and refuel. Reason I'm doing this, I'm going up, is I'm using this as his electronic sensors. He's got what you call electronic countermeasures. This is and radar warning. That's the one I want. Radar warning. So if he's got SAMs, surface-to-air missile units around here, like mine, his radar is going to be on all the time too. So I've got to. I'm going to poke up. Hopefully, I'm just going to expose myself very quickly and then pull back just to get a sniff of the air and detect any radar that might be emitting. So this is why my SAMs are in constant motion. If they're not in constant motion, they will die, because there's an orders delay. Once they stop, it will take 30 minutes before any order to them can get them moving again. And in that time, it's easy. There's no way they're going to escape an artillery barrage. And I say this because that's what I would do to an enemy. If I see his SAMs, I'm going to blast them. First thing off, that'll free up my helicopters to do their thing with virtual impunity. In my reinforcements, I have 3 flights of fighter bombers, fencers. They carry quite a load of bombs. RPK is 500-pound bombs. I think they're 5 bombs or kilos. Kilos, perhaps. That's 21. So that's a lot of ordnance to be dropped here, as well as missiles. So if I can free up my bombers to work without fear of being shot down or suppression, that's going to go a long way. So that's what I'm using the helicopters for. I have my artillery park. I'm going to be lining up here from this general area. It's a little bit lower on elevation 1, so I can hide behind the feature. It's in some slight forest here. I don't know what they call these. Not a thick forest. It's just a copse of trees, I guess you might call it. By hiding and one little elevation level down, he's going to have to get fairly close to actually see them, and that's where I'm going to be firing my artillery. I have a number of reconnaissance units. I am going to. Here's my first one. I'm going to be sending just to help watch. I'll use Control Shift L to see this. So between the two of these, I'm hoping that we can keep an eye on this general approach if he wants to be snoopy and come through. I have an air defense unit. I'm keeping some 2 air defense units in the north. Here's the other SAM unit, because I want to keep the enemy guessing. Am I in the northwest or in the central? If I put all my units in the north or south, I would give too much away. Plus, if I leave this uncovered for any even for a short while, he might be able to fly a helicopter in and spot it or bomb it. This is quite exposed. I recognize it's quite a gamble, but I'm fairly safe that it's a quick start and we're going to go right into the city. Once we go into the city, the concealment offered should be fairly decent. I'm going to note one thing here. Let's see. My positions, I'll just show all of them. I'm pretty much going, here's the first line of a city or fields. I'm staying off this, out of this first line of visibility. Instead, I'm hiding 1 hex back behind them. This should give me enough concealment from these heights. This is a 3 hex height, so it's quite dominating off this ridge, and in the hill, the forest in the middle is probably where we're going to have a big fight. But until I'm ready to go, I'm going to rearm, refuel, and just wait. Let my artillery and my air support do the work to prepare the battlefield. However, I can't sit totally silent. I'm going to be sending one armored or reconnaissance car into the village to see what I can see, even if I don't expect him to survive. But the effort will reveal the enemy and give me targets for my artillery. In further, just north of them, I have three armored cars, reconnaissance vehicles. I'm sending one through. He'll see the change here, and hopefully that will give him pause rather than trying to challenge me for it immediately. If he's coming from anywhere in the west side, I suspect he doesn't want, these are quite distant, and he won't want to challenge me for them right away. He'll grab his easy points and sit on them, and that's what I'm hoping for. If he sees these change color, he might give it second thought and say, well, maybe not today, I don't have to fight for them right off, especially if he's spread out. That's why I want to give him pause. So I've got an armored, this reconnaissance car will be sitting on these woods, and they will give a little bit of early warning. Unfortunately, it's quite exposed, so if he's counter-detected from the heights or from the forest, he's going to die very quickly. Quite a valiant death, but he's going to be conducting reconnaissance by dying, or acting more like a tripwire with his death. I'm sending one armored car into the north. I don't expect him to survive, but I've got to make the enemy try. I've got the helicopter covering this area, and another one covering this general area, so that he can't know that where my main thrust will come. That's my strategy. Let's see how it works. My deployment goes forward. The helicopter I guess it's a quick patrol, doesn't reveal much, nor did my helicopter as he peeked over the ridge. I capture the first victory point location, and the second. We're racing for the heights. No enemy has been detected yet. My first anti-tank platoon arrives in the forest and goes into a hold position. No counter detection yet. My second anti-tank platoon arrives. And my third, my anti-tank company is settled. My reconnaissance company has actually survived. I'm quite surprised that it's actually made it all the way to the woods, and there's no white dot. This is a dot that appears on the marker when I've been detected by radar or laser dot. I could be under visual observation too, and I call this the death dot personally. Just because once you see it, once it's on your unit, that's it. Your unit, you're toast. My reconnaissance vehicle is now ensconced safely in the field, and nothing has come within detection range. Excellent. Same with my reconnaissance unit in the north. So we can control, not quite dominate, but we do have significant observation over this northern area. And with my patrols in the south, I'll at least be warned if the enemy tries to penetrate from the south and hopefully from the center. Once I make sure that my units are safe, then I can pound the enemy. If I can locate them with the helicopters, I can set my artillery to work. The scenario is 12 hours in duration, so I've got lots and lots and lots of time. I don't plan to be moving out of here, out of my casern, my I guess pseudo casern, for at least 6 hours. So the first 30 minutes have passed, I've got a whole bunch more, and I can hammer the enemy. We'll check the order cycle, so we're approximately on 31 minute decision cycles. Our decision cycles are fairly close. I'm at two. Mine first one was 27 minutes, so shorter than his, but my next one is going to be quite a bit longer. Guess look, it looks like I'm doing a lot and I'm moving around. Maybe, I don't know how that's calculated, but the electronic warfare is high. So maybe I'm having problems getting my orders out. Never figured that out, never understood it. I just take it, whatever it says, it says. I have 16 orders allowed, so I've taken the liberty. I've in the north, I was originally going to stop on this hex, but I'm getting a little bit big for my britches, so I'm going to try to push them ahead a little further and spot from this area, because from this location I can really look into the enemy's backyard and see if there's anything, any nasty surprises waiting for me here. Of course, this kind of taking this kind of risk could end up getting me killed, but that's what recon is for. As Patton used to say for his troops, drive down that road till you get blown up. Well, pretty much the same here. My reconnaissance platoon has entered the woods, and I'm going to push him right across down to here. He won't be seeing much, but I'm going to refuel and rearm, and then I will try to sneak him off out into one of these locations. Maybe not here. If I can spot him from the north, if I survive to get to that location, I've got this pretty much nailed. So I will retask my infantry, my reconnaissance platoon, instead of here where he's pretty much blind in the whole hex, to maybe in the south, either south to watch this approach or to this one. I don't need to risk him because he's pretty much like an ace in the hole. If I have access to this entire area, if I can walk, if I can control this area, I've already half the battle is won. I don't have to worry about counter detection by the enemy. My forces are still gathering. They're still moving into their ad hoc casern. My infantry has arrived early, and I am immediately sending them to resupply. They enter on a hold mission or a hold order, but now that I can see that the enemy is no immediate threat to me, I always put them on a hold mission, just because at any time I might have to drop into a hold and protect myself if I get hit by artillery, run over a minefield, get detected, whatever. So it's always more prudent to end with a hold order than a resupply order, because if the enemy spots me on resupply, he might just be able to chase me out with his combat binoculars. I don't know if they've changed that in version 2.06, but I suspect they haven't. So if the enemy spots me, that's just looking at me is sufficient to chase me away from a hex. That's why I go with the hold order. Now that there is no enemy around here, I'll waste one of my 16 orders, permitted orders, to order this stack to go to resupply, resupply, resupply. Even though our ammo is quite high, 98%, and readiness is fairly decent, 75.4%, every bullet counts. Readiness drops dramatically as we start moving or enter combat or are hit by artillery fire, for example. My major pile of tanks platoons are also arrived in their location, so they're going to go to maximum and resupply too. I have my reconnaissance, I guess corks we could call them, or trip wires, and they have some excellent vantage points, but the enemy has not counter detected me. There's no death dot here, so I'm waiting. I could go rearm, but they're fairly high, and if you're not moving, your readiness will recover slightly, so I should be able to recover to near 100% readiness without having to use the actual resupply operation. This one's a little bit weaker, but he's going to be hopefully sitting here for a little while longer. My helicopter is going to do another sweep. Didn't detect any SAM, so I'm going to go pop up, down, and around. I've got enough eyes on the ground. I don't need to be risking him in, let's say, more threatened hostile areas. My artillery has arrived in their little holdout hideouts, and they're rearming, getting ready for a full load. My SAMs are still moving, on the move. It's like the Legionnaire movie, March or Die. And that's the same thing here. If you're either on the move or you're dead meat. I have my reconnaissance in the middle, and he's got some very pretty, these very low areas are misleading. Theoretically, we can see into these areas, but the low values means, I never understood I just take them as percentages of detecting something. And in general, if it's as a rule of thumb personally, if it's under 50%, don't expect it to see anything, especially the little scimitar tanks that the enemy likes to use. These are the little reconnaissance, let's see, where are they? Recon tanks and scorpion recon tanks. These are like ants. They're bloody well difficult. You can't, there's no visibility, there's no radar cross section or visibility cross section, so you can't tell these. This is just from experience. They're very, very hard to do. He could be driving up this road, and I would not even see him, even if he passed here. But I probably would not see him until he hits some of these values here. So, not the greatest. I would go into resupply, but I'll have to take my chances. If I go, I'm in dug-in posture right now. If I go into resupply posture, I go into its covered posture, not dug in. And covered posture, I believe, makes it a little bit easier to detect me. So I'm going to have to suffer the slightly low ammo. Same in the south. I've got my anti-tank platoons are in position, but I'm not going to resupply, even though they could use a little bit more. The readiness is low, so they will not respond quickly if the enemy decides to make his approach. But if I go into resupply, they could possibly reveal themselves too early. And right now, I can't risk giving myself away. The surprise element is just too important. If they get a shot off, all they need is to hit once, and they will have earned their keep and paid for their destruction, because they don't last long. Now, it's significant to note these units are 6 units from the HQ. 6 units from HQ. When out of command range, let's say we'll take a look at this and we'll examine this one. This is the unit. Here is the headquarters for that unit. I'm moving the headquarters quickly to another bridge to try and blow that again as part of my overall strategy. I want the enemy thinking there's something going on out here, regardless of whether or not it's true. But he's outside command range. We'll use Control D to show this is the range of his command radius, of his command influence. And these units are under his command, but they're outside his range. So what we're going to do is the next best thing. The game will allow us to resubordinate. So I'm selecting this one. He's going to act as my ad hoc command unit. And I'll take my anti-tank platoon, and I'm going to move it and subordinate it to him. By doing so, we'll click on it and click on it again just to refresh it. We are now within 5 hexes of a command vehicle. I'll do the same thing with this one, and the same with my more distant one. See? Now they're no longer in red, so this one is still out of range, and there's no unit for which I can subordinate him, which is too bad. But by doing so, I at least give these a fighting chance, or better, ready. If I decide to resupply, they'll have better response. So this one will not get the bonus for resupply, but it will at least have extend its command range to these. So now in the south, I can issue another one of my limited orders. I'm going to blow that bridge. Also, because this is in a slightly, I guess, hidden fashion. See, I've got two anti-tank platoons covering out front. I can afford to send this one into resupply. He's very high in ammo, but his readiness is low. But I'm going to order it to resupply anyway. He might get some of it. Maybe he can get enough of it back. He's out of range. He's only needs about 20% resupply, so it might be sufficient. So resupply mode has increases when you're in the actual resupply. If you're in just a hold mode, you still get resupply, or you still get readiness, still recovery for readiness, but it comes back at a slower rate. And So by going into resupply, I'm hoping to get right up to 100% as soon as possible. I'm outside of command range. However, because it's not a very high number, I'm hoping that I will still, it's a reduced number, and if it was down at the, let's say, at the 60% level, I might only be getting back up to maybe 80 or 90. But since I'm already near at 80, I'm hoping this will get me up near to 100. And these two are already acting as a tripwires, speed bumps. Should the enemy come through, I'm hoping that he'll give enough warning for this one to complete his resupply effort. Now, looking at this, we hit Control O. Control O is a function showing spottable from this area. So supposedly, I am pretty much hidden until the enemy is going to be right next to me. This, personally, I find this function, it can be helpful, but I often find it misleading. Just because the enemy often picks me up at a range of 2 or 3, his sensors are superior. I'm not sure how this is calculated. Maybe this is being calculated according to what my own sensors are, and not the superior sensors of NATO. So I say it's misleading because I'm hoping that the enemy won't pick me up until point-blank range, at which point I will be able to shoot him in the face. But it's the best it's better than nothing. So this is my visibility. This is Control L showing what I can see, or theoretically can see. So I can't see out of it. These are very low percentages. Unless he has a huge tank column, I probably won't be able to pick him up at this range. So it looks a little bit exposed in the south, but we do have this anti-tank platoon covering it and giving us early warning. In addition, I'm checking over my order of battle to see which of my units are possibly out of command range. And this is a nice little function that shows up immediately in red when something is outside of command range. So we see this, but there's nothing I can do about this one. So this one will close up. I'm going to resubordinate these to other. So here's my headquarters, and it's outside of command range to Red Storm. So what I'm going to do is I can take these and I can temporarily resubordinate them to another command unit. And this hasn't been shown. I've seen no penalty for moving things back and forth. So we'll just do another quick look and see no more red except for the one that we expected in the south. My first section of fencers has arrived. I have no visible targets. If I was a gambling man, I could just throw one out here and have them do a little bit of reconnaissance by bombing. But that's a little bit of wasteful. So what I'm going to do, I have 31 minutes before the next order phase. So this will give me sufficient time to resupply. He's at 90% readiness and 90% ammo already, but I don't have a target for him. So if I don't have a target for him, I may as well resupply, and I've got spare orders right now. So I try to use up every order I have. My tank platoon has blown the bridge, and we're going to inch our way northward to this height, and then from this 3 elevation square, we should be able to support the center and give early warning. I ordered I've used the assault mode for my reconnaissance force because the reconnaissance are quite skittish. If they encounter or detect an enemy unit, they're quite likely to just start running. By sending him on an assault mission, he's less likely and he's more likely to follow the path I set. I've used the waypoint editor, and I'm going to put a delay in for the second one. That's a maximum is 180, so I give it 180 minutes. The reason I do this is I want him to get to this hex. He'll get to here in assault mode. I can take a look and see if there's anywhere else I need to go or respond to, and he'll take 3 hours before he actually moves on to hex point 2. At that point, I can decide all kinds of things. I can either send him to rearm, resupply, put him on hold mission, whatever. But it gives me that flexibility because he's already going to take 30 minutes before he even starts moving. And then once in motion, I want to keep him in motion or at least have that option whenever possible. Other than if I just have him stop right here where I intended, if things change, it'll take another 30 minutes for me to issue orders and for him to start moving. And that's just silly, because the artillery and the enemy response is quite often faster. My Tunguskas, I retasked them. Instead of moving upwards, I'm going to move them back in here. I get, as I stated earlier, I have to show some activity, some life in this area in order to keep the enemy attention drawn away from the northeastern sector. There's only 2 minutes to the British orders. Here we go. We have a slight movement delay in the north where the tanks must have stacked up, but not too bad. If you don't take precautions, you can have just huge traffic jams. My units continue to deploy into the town. My scouts move further westward. Still no contacts. Here's an enemy. Looks like we have 1-2 enemy surface-to-air missile units. These are the ones that are the greatest threat to my helicopters. I need the helicopters not so much for offensive assets as for eyes and ears. With them, they threaten the land forces. So even though they may not be a heavy hitty, and they do give out great deals damage, but they don't need to kill anything. They need to spot it for the artillery and for the tanks and for the airstrikes. Another unit appears. I wonder what this one. Oh, armored personnel carrier, 6 anti-tank. So this looks like an infantry unit, a specialized anti-tank unit. Here are my orders. I've tracked in on the SAM unit on this location. He's trapped in the woods. We've lost track of this one. He was moving south at the moment, so he could be here or here, and we just lost track of him. So that's not good, and I don't want to be wasting artillery on an unknown target. But we know this one's trapped in the woods, and I think we can catch him before he goes. So I've ordered 2 batteries, 2 companies of howitzers to plow the woods here and catch him before he can exit, if he's trying to exit at all. If he placed him in here, that was just a bad placement, which is why I've got my SAM units are constantly on the move. It's like the French Foreign Legion, march or die. This is an anti-tank unit, 2 armored personnel carriers, 6 anti-tank units, so squads. So I've allocated 1 more of my artillery units. We're going to try to catch him on the road. We'll probably miss him on this one location, but I'm going to try to hit him there anyway, and then I'll hit him in, probably catch him in the woods. He's under observation by the guards, by the reconnaissance platoon, so he's just there for the plucking. We don't have the death dot on us yet, so we unlikely that we're spotted. We're hiding in the woods. My other reconnaissance platoon is just resupplying now. He's in the middle of everything, and he's going to keep his options open. In the south, we're going to blow another bridge, and we're going to keep our SAM units moving, as well as our higher or up. This is the brigade headquarters. When he dies, they'll track on it, and he'll smoke them if we don't move them. I'm going to move my artillery up, trying to hide them behind the ridge, so that their mortar range is very limited. So 5 kilometers. So I'm trying to bring him within range of this village by hiding him here out of observation range. My helicopter is going to go up. Now, if the last position of the SAM unit was here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1 more. So this is the range of his surface-to-air missile unit. I'm hoping to get in quick, over and out. If he decides to come down the road further, maybe we will smash a few of him on the open road. My units have mostly arrived, and we are now under resupply. We want a full load. Even though they're at very high level, I want a full load. My other helicopter is sitting in the core where it landed. We're below level, so I'm hoping that he can't be seen. Now, this is a bug that's just come up in 2.06, this death dot. While a death dot is, I found, very, very useful, it lets me know when I'm in trouble. Problem is, it doesn't go away. And I'm pretty sure this is a bug simply because it didn't happen in zero in any of the previous versions. When the enemy lost contact with you, it disappeared. But he hasn't lost contact with me, and he keeps it on here. So I can't know if my helicopter is actually under threat or if he knows where it is. So I've got him on the ground landing. He theoretically, in 2.06, they're allowing artillery to hit him on the ground. So if he hits it with an artillery barrage, I'll be really pissed because I can't know if I'm actually, if he actually knows where I am, is guessing well, or whatever. Just another 2.06 bug. Because of his two SAM units here and here, I'm not risking my, I have a flight of fighter bombers that have been waiting to go for a little while already, but I'm not, that since the beginning of the game, but I'm not going to risk them in the face of heavy possible heavy opposition. They're valuable in a sense. They're 71 victory points, worth about 50% more than a tank, but the fact that I can strike deep behind the lines with these is more important to me than their actual damage. Well, not their damage, than using them right away. So I've got to be patient, take out the SAMs, and then go after the ground units with the bombers. Here we go. Oh, another unit's been detected. What the heck is this? That's not good. Another armored personnel carrier. No, it's anti-tank. He's got a few of them here. And some scimitars. So I'm going to be in trouble. But at least we've caught him in ambush. But kind of worthless. We can't kill anything. Maybe the helicopter will come through and be able to sweep a little bit of it. But he's still underneath the SAM umbrella here. So long as he's under the surface-to-air the rapiers, I think they are, umbrella, protective umbrella, I can't dare come in too close. First artillery barrages land. No effect. There goes my first reconnaissance unit. Sounds like there's a tank in here. Look at them. Look at them all. Yep, he's got a headquarters unit, and the visibility's just dropped to 2,000, so I'm in real trouble here. Not real trouble. It helps my force hide, but it means he can sneak up upon me, too. The first air defense rapier has been destroyed. We still have three more salvos going in, and the second one's destroyed. They come in units of two, so I think that unit is dead. Here comes my artillery right onto his position. We're getting secondary explosions. Excellent. A Milan, that's an anti-tank guided missile launcher, as well as a Scimitar reconnaissance unit. Tank. Now, what's this up here? More anti-tank. So he's really loading up. He's trying to make this a killing valley. He snuck in here, so looks like I'm going to have to bring the artillery or the airstrikes down on him. This is probably my next target because he's got someone into the woods. If he's got someone in the woods, he can observe he can surprise and possibly destroy this reconnaissance unit. But he's loading up the north with anti-tank, and he's already had one retreat. Oh, yeah, and he's firing on me. There he goes, another reconnaissance vehicle. And the third one's finally dead. The helicopter starts to approach, but it'll be too late. Over to the British. The helicopter comes in, makes her approach, and launches. Kills one of the anti-tank gunners, armored personnel carriers. Finds, this is the recon unit that was missing before. But we also have eyes on the SAM unit. Oh, great, a couple more armored personnel carriers are taken out. But we're keeping eyes on this SAM unit. My orders are for the artillery. We've noticed that the SAM unit is here and he's holding back my air operations. So I'm going to plan 3 fire missions. The first fire mission of each battery is going to drop here. Unfortunately, he had a little red arrow showing that he was moving in this direction. That may or may not be right. He could be going south, but that's all I've got to go on, and it seemed to be moving in this direction. So I'm going to drop the second battery here. In case we miss him here the first time, we should catch him in the second. This is generally open ground with, coverage is 30% here and 20% here, but it's pretty much open ground. So even if we don't see him, I'm hoping that should be enough to kill the damn thing and open and allow my bombers to start their missions. We've noticed this reconnaissance unit has pushed into the woods here. He could move in further and discover this unit. So the third barrage from each of them is going to try and take out this one. I think we've already killed one of them en passant. Let's try it. Let's take out the unit. Have to click somewhere else. Now we try. I don't see a cross anywhere, so we're not certain if we could have killed one here and on the way through, and there may only be one of his two scimitar, or is that a scimitar? Scout units. We noticed that one of the anti-tank units has run off to this hex, and the last one was hit here, moving northeasterly. So he might be in this hex. So I'm bringing in a helicopter on assault movement mode, so he'll pretty much fly this entire route. We'll bring him over top of this one. By flying over top of him, we'll hopefully have a chance to engage from here, 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 and here. So we'll get a few extra opportunities. We'll fly past him again. We'll be within range, hoping that we will be able to engage him and then fly off in this direction and maybe hit this one. If he's moved over here, we'll hit him a couple of times and then fly back out to rearm and refuel. If we come in just quickly or too close, they may not have an opportunity to engage. It may just fly in and fly out again. So that's why I'm actually overflying the target. It's more a risk, and I'm bringing in close range, but I get to also use my rockets against his tanks. So I can't be playing it safe forever, and I do think it's worth the risk for the helicopters to take out these anti-tank units. The artillery had better kill this one, because if it doesn't kill it, this helicopter could be in very deep doo-doo. The range is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so the range is right up to this point. And we're flying fairly deep into it. We can theoretically be engaged all along here. So I could lose the entire flight if I'm not careful. But I think it's a risk worth taking. The reason is, if the anti-tank unit gets to the edge here, it with the visibility at 6,500 meters, his sensors just might be enough to detect the mass of tanks hiding in the city. I'm hoping not, but it's always possible. We'll take a look. The sensors here, we don't have enough information. Unfortunately, it doesn't give us enough information to know whether or not we could be. See, here's a thermal imaging system on his, if it's a tank, but I think it's this one, the Milan, is a land unit. I think it was an infantry unit carrying the Milan that we were hitting most of, but they also have a thermal imaging system. Unfortunately, we don't know the range, the limits, the sensitivity of that system. So he'll probably pick up the reconnaissance unit here, but he may or may not be able to detect the units in the city. I can't take that chance, so I'm going to try to take him out now. In the south, we're still going to blow this bridge. Our SAMs are still moving back and forth, drawing fire. The headquarters unit is sitting in its own little field. It has a whole playpen to run around in case it needs to displace. I'm leaving it on screen so that if it's emissions are detected, it will displace automatically. If I try to move it and assign it a movement order right now, it'll take 30 minutes before that order responds, and by that time it'll be toast. So even the top unit in the entire headquarters takes 30 minutes to respond to its own orders. In the south, we're moving up. We've blown the bridge. We're going to move up to an ambush position here so I can, if he comes anywhere around it within one hex, we should, I'm hoping to get the first shot off. He'll die valiantly. My other two anti-tank units are sitting here. I could go into rearm and reload, but they're fairly high up with 93 and 94% ammo. By going into a reload or resupply mode, I'd be going into covered posture as opposed to the dug-in posture, and that can reveal my position. So more importantly, right now, I need to make sure it stays hidden as best I can. So since we're not moving, we'll recover readiness at a rate of 16% per hour. So within our next mission is about 26 minutes, so it's almost half. We should be getting about 8 more back, so it'll be about the 90% level. And yeah, same thing here, about the 90% level. So it'll be fairly good. So within an hour, it should be back to full readiness. I'm trying to keep my ace in the hole. Whenever she pops up, she'll be able to spot for everyone along the term. But she's got to stay alive. Here we go. There's Mr. Sam. One minute's passed. Come on, stay dumb. All my units have fully resupplied, mostly. All that were on resupply. Come on. We still got our eye on it. 3 minutes have passed. Where's the fire mission? Let's hope the RT gets here. Here it comes. And we're rewarded with two secondary explosions. Caught him on the road. He's toast. We've temporarily lost sight of the reconnaissance unit. That's okay. We know where you are. We'll be back. Now, some might ask why what a waste of artillery I'm putting into this hex. That's very true. I am firing off, but it was worth it trying to catch this one little unit and wipe him out. Now I've got a fairly free hand. I haven't detected any more SAM units around, and I don't think there are too many. We would have detected them by now with the helicopters flying around at different altitudes. I would have at least smelled the radar. So we have no stiff. Of course, there could be still man portable air defense systems, man pads, which are just rockets or missiles carried by infantry. When we do have one kill, maybe it's enough. But we'll never know. We'll always be, there's no way to kill all of those small Stinger teams or other, maybe may not be Stingers, but they're small surface-to-air missile teams. But at least we've taken out the major threat, the surface-to-air missile units. My howitzers begin their move to the ridge. The battlefield conditions are even longer, 7,000 meters. That's incredible. That easily covers this, but we just don't know how strong his sensors are. The headquarters has displaced actually two hexes. It's moved twice already because the enemy's been tracking on it. So we're really running down the readiness of this unit. But I got no other choice. Here comes the helicopter. With a little luck, he'll fly through and redetect or reconfirm whether this one's destroyed or not. We may have to re-engage with the artillery. It's a quick resolution, nothing much happening here. Here are my orders for the next 24 hours. Notice I am inside the enemy's decision cycle, so my 24-hour notice, or 24-minute cycle, will occur, start, and end within his 29-minute cycle. So I get to shoot and shoot again before he even gets to react. For my next 24 minutes, I have allocated my... Now with his air defenses destroyed, I am going to risk my fighter bombers. I've called in the airstrike right on top of the town that he was holding. I remember there were quite a bit of activity here. We destroyed one reconnaissance vehicle coming out here to scout or to penetrate the woods, and now I'm sending in the airstrike. I've given the airstrike a little bit of leeway up to 2 hexes, so up to around here. If it detects anything, it will still be able to attack in case he's moved assets or trying to move his units outside. My helicopter is going in to scout. We noticed, remember, that there was an anti-tank unit here. I think we destroyed most of its vehicles, but it's still on foot. So I think it's moving in this direction, and one just disappeared into this area. So we're going to sweep through, hopefully catching him here, or maybe the other vehicle, this one still had vehicles, may have moved a little bit further. I brought the artillery in. I'm going to hammer the town, plus I'm going to hammer where I'm hoping it'll catch him here. With only a 3-minute response time, 4 minutes in this case, we're going to hit it within four minutes. If we can hit it within 4 minutes, I'm hoping that notice the hex has a move of 20% restrict, so it's quite slow moving through here. It's heavily forested, so if he slowed down here to try to move across, I'm hoping to catch him here. I need a little bit of luck, but he could really have gone past already, because he was moving last turn and I've lost track of him. However, these down here are moving on foot, so I've got a battery, a company of howitzers hitting him here. Within 4 minutes, I don't think he would have moved past here. Again, he could if he's. I don't think he was moving at that high rate. All my other units are still holding back and in hold positions. Now they're all rearmed, refueled, just waiting to go. My light mortars, I guess you could call them my mortars, are moving in. Soon, once they arrive here, they'll be able to bring this forested hex under fire and cover most of this element here. The helicopter is rearming, refueling. Yes, it's at pretty high level, 63% ammo. It's not too bad, but if I have a chance, one of the things that I always worry about is when sending in a helicopter, if it shoots itself dry, it does some really weird unsafe things. It'll start running back at high speed. It'll go directly back to the headquarters where it tries to resupply, and it kind of points out the enemy where the headquarters is sometimes. It flies right to it, and it goes at an unsafe speed. At least if I'm moving, when I'm in control of the helicopter, I can always order it to fly at either assault or deliberate movement speed. Once it goes into my experience is once it goes into hasty move, it seems to be much more exposed, and I take incredible losses from it at that time. So for that reason, I try to keep the resupply under control by never allowing it to drop down to zero by itself or dropping down to when the automated resupply routine kicks in. So even though we're fairly high, I'm going to keep it up high. I have less use of it, but I think I have better use of it. Here we go. Most of my helicopter sweeps are just to draw the enemy fire, because I don't see him around here. But there we are. See, by going in, I can draw his fire, so I know where I can aim my artillery and airstrikes next turn. Here's his scimitar. There, we've caught his anti-tank unit. And we've caught a couple on the ground, two more Milan launchers. Oh, wonderful. We got a tank unit and some other kind of tracked unit up here. We might lose something, but it's a headquarters unit. So if we can wipe this out, we can slow down his order cycle even more next turn. This is a expensive mission. I hope it doesn't cost me too many helicopters, but it was worthwhile. He's moving in tanks to cover, trying to make this a valley of death. And this, which he would be if he had his anti-tank, would dominate the road all the way down to here. So it's important to conduct the reconnaissance up here. I have to pay the price. We're hitting the Milan. And catching him in an open field, that helps. But this... Oh, and another tank unit. So we have two coming in, plus a headquarters unit, plus another Milan unit. This is a gold mine. I'm glad I sent the helicopter, because he would really be open. He would hold my entire force at risk if they decided to traverse this road. That really would have been a charge of the Light Brigade and the Valley of Death. Some might question the value of sending such high explosive or high caliber artillery against infantry units, but it's the only way to make sure they die. The light mortars may or may not, and so I need those anti-tank guided missiles are quite potent, and they're easily, these little 5 or 10 point anti-tank teams can easily take out a 60 point tank. So a 600% return on investment either, easily. More explosions from the anti-tank teams. And from the town. There's that recon unit again. The visibility stays high. If we get into a storm or rain shower, this all drops to nothing. And the utility of my helicopters is minimized. We've still got a few fire missions to finish. And wonderful secondary explosions. Hoping I catch most of his vehicles here to prevent him from moving out quickly. And then we can hit him again this next turn. But it looks like we got tanks to deal with, and I want to take out this scimitar here, or this recon. I can always come back to the town. I think he's going to squat on the town. So this is kind of a target of opportunity, where these are mobile targets, so we have to hit them as soon as possible. My other helicopter has fully resupplied. The SAMs keep moving and keep the enemy guessing. This is three-card Monty. Here comes the airstrike. I'll hit the town or other towns every time I don't know if I don't have an opportunity for the airstrike. So this way I get to use the airstrike every time. But next time, I know it's coming right up here hunting for those tanks. We still see, oh, that looks like an infantry unit there. That looks like a normal infantry unit with a heavy machine gun. That's what it was from the icon. Some might ask, why am I flying my helicopters here? I've flown them. I didn't land them just behind the ridge, because if the enemy sees me flying across here, he might think, oh yeah, I'm going to stop just behind the ridge, and he might just decide to drop his shells on top of here, because the helicopters are now landed trying to rearm and reload. So by keeping one hex further, I'm hoping that if he decides to get smart and try to take out these hexes with his artillery, he is going to be out of luck. I'm playing every card I got, because I'm playing against a smart human and not just the AI. Here's my second turn. I still have two turns, so I can allocate even more airstrikes and artillery before the British have a chance to react. With my second order phrase, I'm sending the helicopter back in to scout, but I'm also dropping the artillery. I have my mortars in range, but they're just outside range of where I want to hit, so I'm going to blast along these hexes in case he's moved, and I'm still not certain if I've actually killed off the last of that anti-tank platoon. I really don't like those anti-tank guided missile teams, because they can be so effective. I'm also bringing the heavy artillery in on this hex. I'm bringing two companies on it, because there was a tank here. Tank here and here. They were moving in the northeasterly direction. So if this tank has moved out here and the other one has replaced it, I'm catching one of them here. So I'm hoping that I'll be able to wipe out this tank unit with two companies of fire. I left the other one because I don't know if I'm going to miss them, so I didn't want to waste it. I think I'm pretty safe if I'm hitting the one in between it, and the other one will move in should they both be on the move. I'm also going to try to take out the scimitar unit. They are pesky because they don't have a lot of firepower, but if they sneak in and get a look at my tanks, that could ruin the entire plan. The airstrike is also centered on this hex so that we can, with one hex leeway. So I know there's a headquarters unit here, but that's just low-hanging fruit. He's not moving anywhere quickly. I'll take him when I have an opportunity, unless the enemy wants to run out of there like a scared rabbit. I don't suppose he's going to do so. Here we go. So I'll hit him if we don't wipe out the tanks first. First barrage arrives over top the enemy reconnaissance units. Two explosions are noted. Looks like this one's wiped out. This was a suspected tank location, and the first barrage brings nothing. A suspected anti-tank infantry unit is hit and the barrage brings nothing. The mortars drop on it. Looks like we're churning a lot of soil for nothing. What a shame. What a waste of high explosives. Oh! One secondary explosion. Two! Wasn't a total waste. You never know when using artillery how much, so I over allocate because I just never know. I need it dead. Another explosion. Hopefully this is a tank. That's three explosions so far. Four. Wow, and a tank. This is a suspected. We think that the anti-tank infantry unit has moved off in this direction, but we're not certain. So we're just hitting. Looks like we just destroyed a bunch of forests for nothing. Wow, here comes the airstrike. Look at all that. There's tanks, and what is that? Looks like a scout unit or a headquarters unit. Most likely. I wish we would have taken out the tanks. They are more valuable. So two chieftains and a ferret. So that looks like we hit a headquarters unit. Here, oh no. It looks like there's still something alive here. Something's moving here, and I don't know what it is. A tank has been detected just outside by my recon unit and takes it under fire. This is not good. This recon unit cannot survive for long if the enemy has detected him. But he served his purpose. He's found a tank unit, and we're going to be dropping more RT and possibly an air mission on these. Two tank platoons. They're worth about 100 points each, so that's 300, 600 more points. Here comes that headquarters unit again, and the tanks. We've launched on the headquarters unit and killed two armored personnel carrier. So there's one headquarters squad left over. Perhaps the RT can take it out. This is a helo. So the enemy is revealing himself. My orders are, I'm dropping artillery on each of these platoons. Even though it only says one tank is a one chieftain tank here, I might have only spotted one. For example, these numbers aren't exact. There says four here and three here. I suspect there's three in each, and this is just being misreported. Fog of war. My helicopter is still going to sweep through. His ammo is readiness is still pretty good, so I'll sweep through and then fly back for rearming. His enemy helicopter is coming out, so I'm bringing my SAM units to the forefront, and we're going to take a pass through here. Normally, I would like to fly to travel on the higher ridge in order to have better field of fire, possibly right over this and fire right at him, but I can't seem to get much in the way of, well, we can try that. This way, I'll get a couple of hexes travel on top of it, and that should give me my line of sight to him, even though he's quite distant. The reconnaissance unit here is about to die, but he's opened fire, and he hasn't been counter-detected yet. Doesn't seem like it is. Yet there's no death dot here, so I've got my fingers crossed. He probably sees the line of fire coming in, so he's going to eat artillery regardless of whether a tank's kill him with direct fire or not. My helicopter in the south is going to make a sweep. He's still trying to draw fire from this. I can't remember if there was anything detected around here, so he's making a sweep, staying approximately at 1 kilometer or 1.5 kilometers around away from these hexes, seeing if we can't entice the enemy to reveal himself. All my other SAM units are also coming out. Unfortunately, I've used up all my fighter bombers are rearming right now, so they're out of action for the next few minutes, and I won't have access to them. My mortars are able to fire, and they're just in range of the headquarters unit, so maybe I can wipe this one out and reduce the enemy's command decision cycle even further. Here we go. Another tank. Lots of tank, but we hit him with an anti-tank guided missile. Wow, that was quick. That was quick shooting. Quick draw. Oh, and another. We have more. So there is still another scimitar and this is a Spartan anti-tank mobile unit. So lots of new targets to serve next turn. The recon unit managed to kill a tank. That's quite amazing. And still remains undetected. My mortars start hitting the headquarters survivor squad. Let's see if we can wipe it out and force the enemy command cycle to even lengthen or remove the number of orders he can issue. The mortars were out of range for the HQ units and so they've decided to attack the tank in the south, even though we probably aren't going to destroy it. He still is in an open field, so we have a chance of disabling him. If we don't disable him, we can still reduce his readiness level so that we can actually hold him. If we keep his readiness level down low enough, he won't be able to move out of the hex, and then we can bring in the airstrike or heavier artillery. Our heavy artillery barrage lands where we saw the tank last, but no secondary explosions have been detected. Here come our 122mm. No secondary explosions, but he still hasn't detected our reconnaissance unit hidden in the woods. Small blessings. More RT arrives. I'm hoping the fact that he's in an open field providing no coverage or concealment helps. Also, I'm hoping, I don't know for certain, that by keeping them under observation from the reconnaissance unit, that my artillery results are better, or chances are better than something that's firing at a blind hex. But that's just a gut feeling. I haven't been able to confirm that positively one way or another. Arty, the heavy Arty, claims one tank. A chieftain. The other survives. Let's see if we can take out this headquarters. And I think we got her. Yep. The enemy is trying to return the favor, bringing his RT onto our suspected SAM positions. Nice try. Better luck next time. Oh no! Spoke too soon. He caught two of them in movement, so this is gonna hurt. There goes one. Damn it. A gecko, wiped out. This is one of my most effective. Oh, not wiped out. I guess he two. But that's hurt. That's hurt badly. These are some of my most effective SAMs. Looks like we wiped out the chieftain unit. Three chieftains, dead in a field. He's doing the same I'm trying to do with my helicopters. He's trying to knock out my SAM so that he can freely use his helicopters to search for me and to attack my artillery positions. This mortar unit now has the death dot on it. Now, I can't tell if he actually is spotted by something out here or if it's just a leftover from something some other time, but he... After firing, he's decided to scoot, and he's gone up on the ridge rather than going back behind it. So now he's up and high and openly visible to any unit along here. So it could be something along here, could be something from this ridge, don't know. But that's kind of suicidal behavior that we can't change. More RT drops on the position previously vacated by my two SAM units. He's trying hard, and he's spending lots of his artillery going after me. So that's one... If he's chasing me with artillery, he's not chasing my tanks or reconnaissance units. So I'm kind of curious why he hasn't dropped it on this. He can see the fire emanating from this hex. We kill another chieftain. Looks like there's one more left. I need these long enough to survive and take out his helicopters. The game shows that he's also got some tornadoes, so I'm trying to keep the protective umbrella around my tank forces. That's good. Come on in. Let me shoot you out of the air. The helicopter makes a sweep and doesn't manage to entice any return fire. She'll have to do it again. Here are my orders. I'm only using 6 out of my possible 16. I just don't have enough things to do. I'm moving my SAMs. I'm trying to give them up on the ridge as far as possible. Or in front, trying to bring in... engage this distant helicopter. My firing range is just outside, so if I can move 1, 2, 3, 4, I might be able to bring him within range, but I'm hoping that he'll still engage. The low readiness means that I don't know if the enemy, if I'll even be able to fire on him. So I'm bringing all four across the over the ridge and hopefully threatening him, and then retiring back to the east to rearm and refuel. My mortars are going to help and fire a barrage on this tank, this surviving tank in the field. My artillery, heavy artillery, is also down to 39%, but I'm going to fire they're all going to fire their salvos at this one, hopefully fire themselves into resupply. By firing and then emptying their guns on it, hopefully they'll drop into automatic resupply and be the most efficient, I guess, that way. My helicopter in the south is going to go, is making a second sweep, and this time she's going in closer. Now we swept at 1500 meters, now we're going to sweep at 1000 meters and see if the enemy will open fire. My other helicopter has to rearm and reload, but right now there were a lot of targets select found up here. Two tank at armored motorized rifle, I think platoon was here, and more reconnaissance or an anti-tank platoon here. But it's been quite a while since the helicopter's flown out, and the targets could easily have moved by then. So I'm going to do a little bit of recon by bombing. I've assigned my lone air unit to attack this hex. I'm pretty sure nothing's here, but I've given it an airstrike with a layoff. Well, I can attack up to two hex. I've assigned it up to two hexes around here. So even though I don't suspect anything here, I'm hoping that the pilot will make his attack, select a target around here, and he will report back to me the status or the location of other units in here so that I can attack them with artillery or bombers next turn. So that's, I call this recon by bombing. I know he's in the general area, and I'm hoping I'll hit it, and then I'll find new targets for my artillery. But I'm going to shoot myself into auto resupply, and the rest of my units are still holding tight, letting the artillery work its magic. At the present time, we have inflicted 1600 points of damage on the enemy, and he started off with 9000, so that's just over, what, 15%? Not 15, maybe all close, 18%, not more than 20% damage. So we have a long ways to go, but we still have plenty of time with which to do it, 9 hours. Here we go. My mortars have moved them, scooted themselves out of position, out of range, so I've got to bring them back in order to bring fire upon this forest to cover it. Here comes my first heavy arty. And we kill the final tank. So all the other artillery strikes are going to be wasted, but you can never send too much artillery. The enemy has sent in a reconnaissance unit and is counter-detected by Mike, but we've detected each other, so it's quick on the draw. We'll to see who drops artillery on the other first. My recon unit tries to take out the enemy recon unit. Counter-recon. A self-propelled anti-tank unit is detected right on the objective. He's just captured the victory point locations and is engaged by the Hinds. Enemy artillery respawns. There goes the first recon unit. I'm surprised it lasted this long. Uh-oh, here comes the RT chasing after the SAMs. Good job. Good guesswork on his part. The air defense takes it hard. Two. All wiped out. And we have yet to take down one of his helicopters. His anti-tank unit actually manages to kill a Hind. This is terrible. Terrible shooting. The Hind gets one back, so it's about even, points-wise. But I need the Hinds. Lots of fire exchange, but no results. My mortar takes it hard. And virtually shredded. The scimitar is wiped out on the objective. Excellent. The bombers arrive and we still detect another tank unit. So we've hit one hard, wiped it out, but the other one is still possible for an engagement. We took a shot at the helicopter and missed. I don't think we're going to survive long enough to take a second shot. The SAM unit's wiped out, but another one's detected. Prime target for artillery. A pair of tank platoons, three tank platoons appear. More targets than I've got artillery to serve. Here are my orders. SAM, since the enemy is devoting considerable resources to wiping out my SAMs, it's a time of use it or lose it. They're going to die anyway, so I've decided to try to move them out to this area and try to take a couple of more shots at these helos. Since they're going to be exterminated regardless of what I do, I may as well do the best I can. I brought the arty back on. I still have a few more rounds of artillery before they drop into resupply, and I'm going to try to hit these in the open. Unfortunately, my air support has decided to drop into resupply, even still a fairly high level, but I guess, well, automated, it dropped into resupply, so I'm unable to serve this last target up here. But we'll just have to try to remember that there is one more up here. I've sent the helicopters in. One assault, I'm going to sweep through again, and by the time I'm through, I'm hoping that he'll pick up targets for this artillery and or the airstrike. I'm gambling a little bit that we might be able to wipe these out before my reconnaissance unit is wiped out. I think artillery fire delivered from an observer is more accurate than blind. I don't have enough artillery to take care of this reconnaissance unit, but we'll just remember it. It's in the corner and take care of it next time. I've only used 5 out of my 16 available. Unfortunately, there's just nothing more to do. And if I can't take him out, he can easily fly through and scout out my mass of tanks. Here we go. The light mortars managed to take out actually one tank and a command vehicle, a ferret. Looks like we have a headquarters unit here. The more we hit his headquarters, the fewer artillery missions he gets to fire. The chieftains are really being punished. Stacked up nicely. One unit wiped out. Two platoons wiped out. The visibility remains high. Here comes his other tank unit. See, even though I can't see him, he can see me. And he's moved his 5 chieftains in here, and I cannot even return fire. Another 2 more chieftain platoons wiped out. The recon unit has earned its keep. My tripwire anti-tank is also doing the same. We've identified it. Next turn, this one will be getting both either artillery or an airstrike. The enemy begins to engage my second anti-tank platoon. He does so with impunity because my anti-tank platoon is unable to fire back. It's out of range. Obviously, my mortar platoon is detected, and he's going to die on the ridge. See, in this game, no matter, even once you're detected, and the death dot, that's why I call it the death dot, you will never be able to escape the artillery. If the enemy has artillery superiority, or even just a large amount, you can't run fast enough simply because that you cannot give an order for it to leave. Now this is an automatic scoot, that's great. He automatically ran, but the artillery tracks on the new hex. So even though you can't scoot fast enough, you're going to die. The anti-tank platoon takes another hit, and the artillery is tracked wherever it goes. It, because of the 30-minute delay in orders, your unit, it, once it's detected, can never escape. But because the artillery responds within 3 minutes of an order to fire, while you need 30 minutes to move. But we've detected another one here, so it looks like we've got another excellent target. Well, hopefully he won't be able to hit my helicopter in flight. But we now have a lot of different targets to serve. What's five tanks? He's certainly committing his tanks into a forward position. But we expected to lose this position anyway. That's all right. There's that reconnaissance unit that disappeared. We may have to send the helicopters down south to eradicate. We just don't have enough artillery to take care of all these positions. Here are my orders. I'm trying to use up my mortar platoons or mortar companies. They're going to try to take out this single reconnaissance unit. It only takes one unit to spot the entire area around here, so I've decided I'm going to try and wipe it out. With the enemy artillery so active, I don't dare land here to rearm and refuel. I'm going to pull back further, hopefully by dropping below the radar horizon at a level 1 point, I'll be able to be hidden, because once I land to rearm, I think they're version 2.06 allows for artillery to destroy my helicopters. In the north, I'm taking a very aggressive and very desperate approach. I really need to have these helicopters down. So I'm sending my Hinds right over top of them. Maybe we'll shoot them down in air-to-air gunnery. That's probably rare, but I really, really want them down. The helicopters will then retreat back to this point to rearm and refuel. I've also moved my SAMs out one and then back. I'm going to try to hide. I'm desperate here. I'm going to try to hide them behind this ridge. This is an elevation 3, elevation 2, and this is elevation 1. I don't know if this will hide them from the radar returns, because their radar is going to be on, but it's better than nothing. If this radar, this helicopter still may be able to detect them. I just don't know. My helicopters are so low in readiness that I'm not even, my SAMs are so low in readiness, I don't even know if they'll respond. At 23% level, they're just waiting to die. So it's unlikely they're going to engage. I'm wondering if this helicopter might be actually landed here, rearming and refueling. But I would normally put some artillery on it, but all my artillery is out of in resupply mode, except for the mortars. I have one airstrike ready, and I've brought it in on the visible five tanks. Even though we know that there's another tank platoon here, this is the only one visible at this time. Here we go. We do see another tank here, and the helicopter does manage to take out one of the reconnaissance platoons. We'll take out a tank in the north as well. Have we wiped it out? Quite possibly. That is a good turn of events, but let's hope we have enough ammunition to actually shoot down the helicopters. We see a scimitar, a couple of Spartan anti-tank vehicles. We take them out en passant, but we really want the helicopter. The mortars drop. And we are rewarded with a wonderful, more than one. Could there possibly be another unit here? We thought we had that fleeing reconnaissance unit, but then we saw the other explosions. We do have, we've killed one of the helicopters. Excellent. Two gazelles are down. It would surely be a treat to get all three of them. But we're moving out of range now, so unlikely. We try. Oh, and the SAM just got a launch. Unsuccessfully. See, now that the helicopters run out of ammo, he starts running back. We can see a small 2 here. Perhaps it's very hard to distinguish, but a 2. That means I'm running back at hasty speed. Why would a helicopter be running at hasty speed, helter-skelter, exposing itself even more when it can just fly back at normal speed? Just bizarre. The suicidal behavior of these helicopters leaves much to be desired. My SAMs take a couple of pot shots at the helicopter. Gosh, I wish he'd just take him down. Looks like the enemy's managed to detect me at this range. So that's the end of the masquerade. Time to die. Wow! What an incredible detection range. That's what? 7,000 meters. I don't even know what the hell he saw, but now the jig is up, time to start the attack, because he knows where we are, and he caught the SAM. Whoa, look at that collection of tanks down here, but we're not going to have a chance to get to them. We wiped out another platoon. Incredible. I don't know what he's seeing or how he's seeing it, but he's seeing it. There goes my SAMs. Oh, this should take note. This is a good lesson to be learned. Two more platoons. I've been identified. Yep, we're gonna get creamed out here. I'm just amazed he isn't using his improved conventional munitions. See, these SAMs, they were supposed to go all the way running back here to rearm and refuel. However, they take this road, and then they run into this stacked hex. Instead of taking the outlet hex where they could have gone around it, they just get jammed up here and stop. That's how stupid this AI is in pathfinding. Instead of actually trying to find another way around, now they're jammed up here and unable to move for 30 minutes. Because they're unable to move, well, they're into resupply mode. I'll never get them moving again. They're detected. They're just going to get creamed. So you have to spend a lot of effort to make sure that the AI never runs into a situation like this. It just can't find a way around it. So I'm going to have to move this sucker around it manually, move it around, then repath it. But I'm not sure if he'll survive long enough. At least we'll be able to save one gun out of this. So you have to spend just a lot of time making sure that the AI doesn't run into a barrier such as this. But it does help. We now know where there are other tanks and more over here. But looks like our masquerade is over, and I'll have to launch the attack early because of this stupid helo that picked me up and I could not destroy it. This is what happens when you meet a good player like Goobie. Here are my orders. I've only got 16 of them. I've decided I'm going to assign the bombers to try and take out these two tanks. We killed one tank platoon here already. There's something else here, probably a headquarters unit or an infantry unit, but it was unknown. But we did identify clearly two tank platoons here. I have my two airstrikes going in, trying to snuff them out. They're not an immediate threat to my units up in the north, where the attack is coming in. However, because they do exist, I do want to take them out, and I have a confirmed position on them right now. So I may as well go after them while I can, because he will be responding in some way and probably defending these points if I let him survive. So if I know exactly where he is, may as well try to kill him. Same with these two tank platoons. If I know exactly where they are, I have them under observation, and I think he's got me under observation. I can't tell for certain with this death dot. So I'm going after him with the artillery, trying to smash him before while I know where he is. I haven't fired the lighter mortars simply because I've run out of orders after getting my attack. So I've used up about five orders to get my artillery missions in. That leaves me about 11. I've elected to attack through the north, and I've chosen my motorized rifle troops to lead the attack, to go first. I've sent the northernmost, I'll show the path. I've sent my northernmost motorized rifle company to approach along this path. Now, I fully recognize this is in the open. This is pretty much tantamount to suicide. This one's going to get shot to ribbons, just going to get ripped apart, because I know that he's still got some anti-tank platoons up here, and his anti-tank platoons use the Milan launcher. We have anti-tank, such as the Spartans, have a range of 2,000, and they carry the Milan missile. Also, the other Milan anti-tank had same range, 2,000. So they're very accurate. They're from here, 1, 2. So he's covering all the way down to the highway, and I just have to let him, if he's there or if he's here, I don't know. We didn't have a chance to actually kill him. Maybe they cannot see this far, but I just don't know. This is going to be a charge of the light brigade. This is pretty much going to be a valley of death. So we're sending him down this way. His job is to die gloriously and suck up the enemy fire, draw down his supply of missiles. I've ordered most of them to disembark at a range of 4. That's quite a distance. That's 2 kilometers from the objective. However, I don't expect him to survive. I'll probably be hit anyway. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm hoping he's disembarking from here, but he'll probably have taken losses already, and that means the loss of both the carrier, armored personnel carrier, as well as a subunit. But if I, by disembarking at a range, at a distance, I'm forcing the enemy to shoot twice as much. Of course, it doesn't matter with artillery, but it does matter with direct fire weapons such as the Milan. He only has so many rounds. Every round he has to shoot, he's got to shoot twice in order to kill the squad and then the carrier, or the carrier then the squad. So that's what I'm hoping for with this company. The second company is I'm sending him down through this route. The reason I'm having two different routes is I'm trying not to have them stacked up one on top of the other. By stacking them up one on top of the other, that just gives the enemy artillery better chance to work. So by heading off in a different route, I'm doing a type of staggering them. So hopefully he'll follow up with another unit. The other motor rifle company is coming down this route because he's got further to go. I'm hoping that he'll come in just behind this one, or so, approximately. It's not perfect timing, but close enough. And I'm sending this one. This one's already been decimated by the artillery. We've lost 3 subunits or squads. So we're sending them. I'm going right down the road. So we're having the northern route and the southern route. So we have 2 on the southern route. This one, I'm hoping will be the least damaged. However, a couple of minefields anywhere around here could easily ruin my entire day. But that's 3 motorized rifle companies, that's an entire battalion. I expect them to die. Quite true, honestly, I expect them to be totally decimated, wiped out. I've assigned the other 2 motorized rifle company to try to set up a base here. This would be my second effort if the first one fails, and it should fail. These will resupply and refuel here and then make their final thrust in. If we can, if we are able to even hold it for just a second, it'll change hands, and then I'll force the enemy to come and actually try to retake it. These will be a late game rush that will hold it just near the end, hopefully make their final assault, and then take possession of it and hold it and then die under the artillery. But this is a faint hope. I don't know if I'm going to actually capture this, but I've sent all my motor rifle troops towards it. So that's one battalion, almost two full battalions after this one point. I only have five more orders left, and I can issue orders to five stacks. I've taken this, my southernmost, and I'm sending them as far south as possible, or I'll probably hole up here, but I'm sending them. I normally would like to get them in through here to protect them from observation and use this ridge, but I don't think I can, simply because the enemy has already spotted me, and he's going to be hammering, dropping mines through, and sowing improved conventional munitions as well as high explosive throughout this area. So I'm expecting total failure from this attack. This one will head to the south, and we're going to try to establish a base here. Most of mine are units are trying to run into the woods here for some temporary cover to rearm, refuel, and head south. But I think I'm going to evaluate the attack as we go in. If the enemy is decimating me too badly, I might just send the attack straight into the town, because there won't be any point. The problem is I am approximately 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at least 7 kilometers away. And normally I like to make an approach within 4 or 5 kilometers and then make the final assault, because the readiness, by going in at such a long range, I burn readiness, burn fuel at a very high rate. So by the time I get in here, I might only be, 20 or 30%, and that makes it really easy for the enemy to push me back out, because I can't rearm and refuel. I'll be in view of the enemy and close proximity, and I think 2.06 still has the combat binoculars, where you don't have to even be threatened. All they have to do is look at you, and they'll force you to retreat, and then we won't be able to resupply. They'll retreat into an open field and get massacred there. So for that reason, I try to make the final rush at about from four to five kilometers out. I'm not getting that choice because the spoiler of that helicopter. So I'm sending them as far south. What I'm trying to do to separate them, we'll take a look at the individual group waypoints. I'm sending one group 2 minutes ahead of the other one. This way I'm hoping to get at least a one hex separation, so that if and when the artillery falls on them, he's catching individual unit, not a group. A second unit behind them is also following the same. I'm giving them 2 minute separation. But I've also got this headquarters unit. Now, I can't risk the headquarters in a direct assault, because as I've shown here, we only have 16 orders. If I lose the headquarters unit, I'm going to lose even more orders. I'll probably lose 3 to 4 issue 3 or 4 orders. And if I'm only good, and if I lose a couple of headquarters units, I'll be down to 10. And it's bad enough with 16. It'll be impossible with 10. So I sent them. They're heading down the same general area, but as before, I might just have to throw the attack right in. This is a haphazard attack. So that's 1, 2, 3. Here's another stack that are going in. Same. We've got them staggered with a couple of minutes delay in between. Maybe I'll change that. Instead of 5 minutes, we'll change that to a 4 minutes. So give 2 minutes delay in between. And I've got the headquarters held up 20 minutes. I'll probably hold up the headquarters in these general areas. And we don't actually need the headquarters in the front with their command range, simply because we can always try to make a sec. We can always try to use one of the other company or other tanks as a ad hoc headquarters. The game does not penalize us for doing so. It's just like we did it right down here with the anti-tank. This isn't normally a headquarters unit, but we're forcing it into that role of headquarters simply to simplify or extend the chain. Now, now that the other headquarters is actually within range, the normal headquarters, we're going to order the pseudo or the ad hoc headquarters to relinquish command back to this headquarters. And that's the second tank. Here's my third tank stack. Now this tank stack has a Gopher surface-to-air missile platoon. I'm the range of the Gopher. This is my probably going to be my only my sole surviving SAM. Is not too bad, and the best part of it is it uses long-range infrared. This means that there are no emissions. So I'm going to try to hide him in behind the ridge. The reason I'm trying to keep him alive is we know that the enemy has tornado fighters, and he'll probably want to unleash his tornadoes on me the way I've unleashed my fencers on him. The chance of the Gopher actually shooting him down is probably pretty slim. Only a massed number of surface-to-air missiles can actually get the tornadoes, but by having him in here, at least some threat is better than no threat. The tanks beneath it in that stack are going to head try to reassemble here, and my northernmost are trying to gather here. The problem with all now, I haven't been able to, these other stacks of tanks just can't get their orders. Everything I've issued here is going to take 30 minutes to put into play. This is the orders delay introduced in 2.04, I think it was. So 30 minutes from the point before they even consider moving. This gives the enemy 30 minutes. He's already hit one unit. He's probably got more artillery coming in. So at his point here, he's going to have 25 or so minutes. He's going to be able to hit us twice with when artillery is assigned. For example, we see that this mission, it's going to appear in 29 minutes. That's 4 minutes from now. So we have a response time of 3 to 4 minutes for artillery, but the tanks can't get moving for 30 minutes. This is just absurd. So he can fire all his, he could, if he fires right away, he could fire all his missions. 13 minutes later, or at the next minute, fire another 13 minutes before I can even budge an inch. It's insane. But notice the airstrikes are able to go in after 15 minutes. Here's 11:40. I can call an airstrike for 15 minutes with a 15-minute delay. I can call artillery with a 3 to 4 minute delay, but I can't move a tank company without a 30-minute delay? Absurd. But that's the game we have. So these units won't be moving. I'll be issuing a next set of orders for these uncommitted companies, but I expect I'll lose this one. When the high explosive and mines and improved conventional munitions start arriving through here, it's going to get just messy. They call this Hell's Crossroad, and I think they were probably referring to this valuable victory point location. I think it's going to be more here because I'm trying to come through all this. That's why I'm trying to send some units to the south of it, but they're all in this general vicinity, or not, maybe all in this one hex. It's going to be just a nightmare. A few mine hexes in here can throw the entire attack into disarray. And it's not a big deal. The coverage here is approximately 30% coverage concealment, whereas the more open fields are only 20%. So it's not a huge amount, but every little bit helps considering with the enemy spotting. So if I have to come through here, it's a little bit more exposed than coming down the road. Also, my artillery is unable to fire. I've run out of orders. It's lighter mortars, and I don't expect much from them. Unfortunately, these damn things, my artillery company has decided to migrate all the way to the north from his shoot and scoot. He shoots and displaces, but he displaces some right into the middle of my attack zone, and I can't get him out of there. This one's decided to scoot up on top of a ridge so that everyone can see him. Again, not too bright, but we have no control over where an artillery unit displaces. Of course, it would be nice if we had, if we could tell them which direction to go, then I could have them running around behind the ridge, at least some protection and concealment. But no. AI just decides wherever it wants to go, it just goes. My reconnaissance in the fields just outside of town has already been detected and hit by artillery. We've lost one, so he's keeping the enemy busy. He'll probably be destroyed in the next barrage. Every barrage that lands on him is one less that lands on a tank. Here we go. Oh, this is a new bug that just came up in 2.06. When you hit, we get a double orders phase. Once we hit the start, notice that the clock has not advanced whatsoever, but we are given a second orders phase. We notice that nothing's changed here, but we can't, if we wanted to, we have another 16 orders. This is an exploit. This is a bug. And we could issue orders for them, but for my second echelon to get up, and that would be really, really helpful. But we know it's a bug, and I have to contact all my opponents and make sure, and we all agree. We know it's a bug, and we're not taking advantage of it. When we see it happen, all we're going to do is ignore it and pretend it didn't happen and continue on. And we're gentlemen, and we enjoy playing the game and not taking advantage of each other. So we'll trust each other not to do a double order phase. But that is definitely a bug. And for those unsuspecting, it's not a bonus. So here we go. The tanks advance right into my reconnaissance company. And destroy her. But the artillery catches them. No secondary explosions, though. Possibly because they are unlocalized. They're not spotted fire. This is horrible. My artillery was doing quite well before. Now it seems as though it can't hit the broadside of a barn. We know where he is, and we cannot kill him. There goes my Rabbit SAM launcher running for safety. This is just horrible. I wonder what the heck has happened. Are these different tanks? Or what reason could it be that we've hit so many artillery barrages and can't register a single explosion? We know they're there. Are the only thing that's going to work is airstrikes? Two more become available. Here's a thing that I use with my surface-to-air missile unit. I've ordered them to try and cross the river. Now, I know that it cannot cross the river because he's asked to have a forced crossing. So he'll be stuck up here, but this prevents me from using up my last waypoint. So as he's trying, once I get control back in my orders phase, I can order him to go in a different direction. Now over to my opponent. My artillery keeps searching for those tank units that are missing here. They don't seem to get any results. Here is the spotted, I suspect it's a recon unit. At this point, he's putting it all so far out here, it's got to be recon. Managed to wipe it out. Yep, two units, and that's probably a recon. But he's doing the same thing with my recon. He probably noted the explosion here, and now with the death dot on it, there's just no way to run away. Still punching holes in the air. Let's hope he doesn't get any closer. My airstrike goes in. This is where, against the suspected tank unit here, but it looks like it's found another one. We gave it a leeway, a range of one, so it's going to find something around here. It looks like it found a better target, or the target moved.
Wow, we've got a lot of targets here.
Let's see if we can pause this for a moment to see there's unidentified tanks, unidentified enemy units. Looks like this is the symbol shows an infantry unit, but we can't tell what kind. Looks like that looks like a heavy machine gun, so probably a regular infantry platoon. This has, oh gosh, can't tell that symbol, but it's not just regular infantry. It might be, we'll continue here, an anti-tank platoon. We'll check it up later. The second airstrike goes in as planned, and we're getting lots of explosions. Two explosions. I think we wiped this one out too. But we don't get a reconnaissance report around here, so we to see what else is around. Unfortunately, the enemy is dropping. Has been spotted on my mortar group, and now they're taking it. Well, if they wipe them out, it'll make it easier for the tanks to run over them. That's their fault for doing something stupid as going out from a protected area in right into the open. You got what you deserved, morons. Just too bad we can't somehow curb this automatic AI self-destructive behavior. The enemy continues to conduct his reconnaissance by fire. If you've got the ammo, why not use it, right? Let's hope we can get him out of this ad hoc casern before he hits something valuable. He's already taken out three squads from this motorized rifle company, one of the motorized rifle companies here, and I don't want to give him any more. Here are my orders. Last turn cycle, we saw that the enemy was probing with his artillery, blasting around here. I'm quite amazed. He noticed that there were three explosions here, but he doesn't follow it up and pound it a few more times. But I'm not going to interrupt the enemy while he's making a mistake, in my opinion. He did pound our reconnaissance unit a little bit further, and he did manage to hit some of our artillery. Well, maybe not hit it, but at least he went after it. So it's interesting that he didn't follow it up. However, for mine, now he's given me a chance to deploy the rest of my units, or at least issue the orders. I have the second echelon coming. Now, because of the 30-minute delay, there's no way they're going to catch up to these, unless I, of course, change the orders and have these delayed. But I want to get them out of the casern as soon as possible, because they're going to get hit. And having a 30-minute delay may not be that bad, simply because if he starts dropping artillery or mines or other losses through here, the second echelon will have a chance to avoid that, or at least they'll be giving different targets, and they won't be all caught on the road at the same time, I'm hoping. Now, I've used up most of my orders again, up 14 out of my 16 orders. I'm just glad that he didn't wipe out anything that was important. My Red Storm top headquarters continues to move, and we're just giving him a little playpen. He's scooting about, just run around in, and displace. He displaces every time I think that the enemy has a chance of locating him by radio direction finding equipment. So he automatically displaces if we leave him on screen. However, if that means I can't actually give him an order. If I give him an order, even the top headquarters, that would take 30 minutes before he even starts moving. And in that time, he's a dead man. Unfortunately, with all the scooting around, he's running around at hasty speed, moving one hex at a time. It's still eating up his readiness. He just cannot recover fast enough. So sooner or later, he's going to run out of readiness, drop into resupply, and die. In the south, the enemy's taken out my tripwire. That's what they were there for. They are tripwire defenses. Now we're my other self-propelled anti-tank. We're loading up the final shells. We're going to go to maximum. He's got a firing range of about one, so anything that comes up this road or up this road is hopefully going to get shot in the side, right in the back, before he realizes it. My headquarters company isn't very much. It's got one armored personnel carrier. It doesn't have very much armament, but he's going to die in place. He's doing what he's got to do. He's keeping the enemy focused in the south, as we can see by the concentration of enemy armor and infantry. Fire support wise, I'm bringing the air in again on his two. We had two spotted tank
platoons, one here and one here. Gonna bring it in again. Yes, my attack's coming from the north. I could be concentrating on targets in the north, but I don't see anything. And that's the problem. If I had a known target, I have known targets here, which I can service, but if I knew what was up here, I would hit them because they're more immediate threat. But I'll use what I got. So by the time I find out what's up here, I'm hoping my aircraft will be ready again. And I do have another airstrike in resupply right now. So I've got airstrikes hitting his tanks here. There were two more infantry. Let's take a look at that now. Let's take a look and see which one. It looks like, okay, there was a mortar platoon here, and the other one was a heavy machine, a general purpose machine gun infantry support unit. So we had one with a general infantry support unit here and a mortar unit here. I am allocating, I'm going after the infantry support and after the mortar unit. I have one additional, or not one additional, my last howitzer or artillery unit is going to see what we can do about taking out some of this in the village. I know he's there. I just can't, even though I haven't seen him, this is just too vital a location to ignore. I'm also bringing in the mortars. They're not very effective, but every little bit helps. I can wear him down. My other mortar unit's running like hell back to this cousin where he should have been in the first place, and he'll resupply once he gets there, if he survives. The SAM unit miraculously has been able to resupply. It's still low, but at least we can give it an order. However, with the 30-minute penalty, I suspect he'll be blasted into smithereens before he moves a single inch. I have my second echelon, first echelon, moving forward in to occupy these sections in here. As stated earlier, these are getting delayed orders, so I've given them all three reference points to drop into the same location. Gotta warn viewers that this bug that was reported in 2.05, the previous version, at 2.04 is so, I think too, is still here. If you have multiple waypoints in here, it screws the final. You won't go into hold, you'll drop into something like screen or on call or something else. So by having all three in the same hex, if it actually arrives in the hex, it won't drop into hold. It will drop into some silly screen or other mode, and they haven't fixed that yet and probably never will. So even if you have it at the end or in the middle, it doesn't work. So whatever happens, I'm going to have to reposition these later on, but I'm keeping my options open by keeping them at the end. I'm hoping that if he travels around here, if there's a minefield dropped in around here or other kinds of impediments detected by the enemy, I can always change his route and reroute him somewhere else, hopefully around the wrecks. This is about the only way to avoid minefields. Isn't perfect. The AI still has a tendency to jump on minefields no matter how hard you try to get them away, but it's better than nothing. At least I can try. The second echelon is coming in to fill in behind them. The scouts are going to keep an eye. We can still maintain a watch. They're not very useful, but they're better than nothing. This one here is probably the most important because he's got the cork in the bottle. I've ordered my helicopter. It's finished resupply. I'm sending him on an assault craft. So he's going to follow this path pretty much right through here and sweep in. It's dangerous because I know he's got anti-tank units and other infantry, plus another tank or at least one tank unit survived up here. We never got a chance to bomb it. So one tank unit up here. Now it's use it or lose it time. We're not so much running out of time. We still have 7 hours to fight, but I've got my attack going forward, and I just gotta find out what's here and take out some of that anti-tank if I any way he can. So he'll sweep through, maybe he'll catch something over here in case if the enemy is deploying. The other helicopter is resupplying. I managed to save this one Tunguska, but as long as he's alive, the enemy has to devote attention to it. I'm going to try to run him back here, hopefully behind this little mountain or hillet here. They managed to reload, rearm before, and if I can do it again, before it seems as though the enemy is unable to detect him behind this level 3 and then level 2, and this is a level 1 hex. So this seems to afford him some protection. I'm gambling, but maybe I'll even move him a little bit further. This helicopter may be picking up regardless. At least I can try. His readiness is so low that I have to get him back up there. The other SAM unit, I've learned my lesson. We're going to run out here across and then back up. The only way, we have to manually move him or else we get jammed up against this mass of tanks and armored personnel carriers. Here we go. The mortars drop their first barrage. No effect. The heavy artillery goes after the mortar unit. One subsequent explosion. Excellent. And two. The heavy goes in against the town of... What is that town named? Driven? No secondary explosions. Now we're going after the heavy machine gun unit. Probably just a regular infantry platoon. No secondary explosion. Damn, we still got another shot, and we still can't kill that little son of a gun. He's running back, looks like he's running back to headquarters to rearm. We probably run his readiness down so low. It's important to note, this is good. If we see him here, there's probably a headquarters right underneath us. So we might, if we had extra bombers, it's a good consideration to throw right on here and maybe hammer his higher headquarters. We are hitting the infantry platoon with an explosion here. So it is paying some up, but it's really expensive in terms of artillery. Using up lots to kill him. Just not killing him fast enough. Hopefully it's another mortar. Nope, there goes the helicopter. Keep an eye on him. We're back with the next turn. The enemy helicopter continues to run. Something popped up here. My artillery continues to pound the enemy infantry unit. Let's look. No secondary explosions. We keep dropping artillery into the town. I can't confirm it, but I smell an anti-tank unit just sitting there waiting for us. Now we're going after the mortar unit, the final barrage. It might already be dead. We'd just be turning dead men into the earth. Terrible shooting. No secondary explosion whatsoever. The airstrike goes in, and he decides to bomb the infantry instead of the darn tanks. The secondary explosions are heartwarming, but I need tanks to die. This looks like the command unit. He's got a ferret there, so it looks like it is a command unit. Looks like we wiped out headquarters and two chieftains only, but we still have tanks here and here. Plus two more units here and here. The helicopter goes in on her assault. Now, my mistake was I noticed that there were tanks here, but I forgot there were two tank units here we could have been bombing at the same time. They are much more threatening. So if I have air assets this turn, that's where I'll be heading. I'll be making sure to take these out. The ones in the south just are secondary in level of threat. They may be poised to pounce on this location, but I'm moving out now, so I have to have this location more secure. Here are my orders. I have still 16 orders with which to issue, and first order of business, I'm going to be bringing the airstrikes. Or I actually have only one airstrike. I'm going to concentrate it on this hex here. There were two tank platoons that disappeared after wiping out my reconnaissance unit. For that reason, they could have moved already, and I'm hoping they didn't, but they could be trying to move their way through here. For that reason, I've allocated the airstrike in here, and I've given it a range of 2. So everything up to a range of 2 around here, if the enemy has something, I'm hoping that this airstrike will find it. So it's kind of like reconnaissance by airstrike, and I'm hoping to catch one of them or the other. My mortar platoon is very low on ammo, so I'm going to shoot him into resupply, trying to get off as many rounds as you can, and then he'll automatically drop into auto resupply. While we cannot, I'm guessing only that there's a tank unit here. I'm not sure if the unit would try to force his way all the way through to the other side, or if he's just parked here waiting for my approach. 6 of one, half dozen the other. My helicopter makes her approach. Still hasn't detected anything yet, so nothing for the artillery to hit. Because there's nothing for the artillery to hit, I'm going to be aiming for the tank platoon that would know confirmed to be here. I'm sending 2 artillery companies trying to hit this sucker. And this, there was a survivor. Only 2 tanks were taken out here, so there's probably 1 survivor here. I'm ordering the 3rd one to salvo her 3 salvos on here. The airstrike, well, okay, we've gotten called into the airstrike, and I'm hoping that within, it'll be ready by 12:36 and 12:36, so within 19 minutes, we should have another airstrike. So by the next command cycle, we will have 2 more airstrikes with which to pummel this location. So if we can find something, I can bring the artillery in on north or central. Now that all my artillery missions have gone in, I've noticed that my other missions have been assigned. Odd thing is, they've started moving, but a pair of tank companies seem to be charging out like the light brigade ahead of everybody. Now the other ones are moving, but I also notice in the south there is my anti-tank platoon, and it's been rearming for a long time. Then I notice the bug. This is a bug that sometimes the units don't get their orders. This one should have been resupplied as of 09:48, and it's already 2 hours later, almost 3 hours later, and she still hasn't resupplied. So she's never going to resupply. I'm going to have to waste another order here to resupply. I hope she does resupply before she dies, which makes me worried about what the hell's happening with all these up here, that these were issued the orders at the same time and they haven't moved. My concern is that they may never move. If the bug appears here, they made this delayed command nonsense so convoluted that you can't tell if these will actually execute their orders. So I've got my fingers crossed, but I won't rely on anybody else's competence. So what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to pull back 1 waypoint here, and I'm going to try to edit the delay. So once it reaches this first waypoint, I'm going to try to edit it and add 3 hours onto the delay. I hope it'll take. So it'll sit here and wait for the rest to show up. Even if it doesn't, if it fails to take this order, it'll still be charging no further than its original endpoint. but it's probably going to be charging in alone, or not quite alone, with two tank companies, and they're going to get wiped out, I suspect. I'm going to do the same here. This one already had a 2-minute delay, so it should be theoretically behind the other one, but it may not. So I'm hoping that these modified orders will take hold. If not, the enemy is just going to keep charging through here anyway, and I suspect he'll probably just be wiped out. Now, not every unit is stuck. See, all these infantry units were given orders at the same time as this unit, but they haven't moved an inch. They haven't budged. So, which makes me a little concerned that they might be hit by this bug. I'm hoping not. This tank company has already moved one, and his subsequent ones are behind him. So, it would be terrible to have half my brigade move out while the other half sits on its ass, and I just can't tell. If I have to issue the order again, as we saw with this resupply, we're going to be stuck with another 30-minute penalty while everything else tries to filter out. This is the unreliability of this delay system is just horrible. Just horrible. It's one thing to know what you're dealing with. Previously in 2.02, when you issued it, your units started moving right away. Even they might move at a faster rate or a slower rate, but they moved. And if you were at assault, you were moving at the slowest rate. If you were on deliberate, you moved at a medium rate. And if you were on hasty, you would move at the fastest rate. But you moved. With this 30-minute delay, there's just no idea if something actually got through. So, got my fingers crossed. I have only used up 5 orders, but there's nothing left to give. So, here we go. The tank company moves out. Excellent. And her followers move out. We picked up we killed it's a ferret. Wow, that's a command unit. But this looks like an anti-tank unit. Yes, Milan unit. If we can kill a few of those, it would really help. But more importantly, we've come through here and we haven't seen anything else. So this is a prime artillery target. Looks like the rest of the brigade was not afflicted with the orders bug. Excellent. Thank goodness. But we know it exists. The final tank is wiped out. Excellent. Let's hope we get the other 3 here. No secondary explosion. The second company fires. Come on. Excellent. Another 100 points there. The mortars drop on the suspected tank platoon here. Unfortunately, we've only managed to kill a ferret. The ferrets are pretty much just command vehicles and they're pretty useless. So I wish we had killed a Milan or an armored personnel carrier instead. Unfortunate, but at least we have their position for next turn. The Gopher has made her approach and is now hiding within the woods, behind the ridge. Looks like I'll have no chance to operate. The artillery goes in. We've already killed the unit here, so I think that it's just wasted artillery. But that's okay. Let's see if we can smoke the rest of this tank unit. I think we got one of them. No luck. The mortars try for it. No luck. The helicopters retire to rearm and refuel. They've served their purpose and located the anti-tank unit here. Uh-oh, the enemy's dropping mines right here. And just missed us with the improved conventional munitions by that much. Wow. But he caught one. He drops a mine unit on this tank, and we're trapped in the field. Another miss, near miss. Whew. But we do get caught here. Improved conventional munitions are the death of me, or will be the death of me. And nothing I can do about it. And we hit another minefield. They just won't go away. At least we stacked up. Holy cow, how do we get that many? We're really overstacked on that minefield. That should be technically impossible to have this many units on a hex. So this is probably a bug. We're overstacked right now. Or is it this hex? Well, one of them. The tank just moves right past that, which is okay. Unfortunately, there's a tank here that we missed, and he's starting to prey upon the armored personnel carriers. Another improved conventional munitions salvo misses just behind us. The enemy doesn't get too many of those. He's sure using them up quickly. But if I was in his shoes, I'd do the same. Use them or lose them. Another mine appears in the south. So you got to keep track of where all these mine locations are. I think one's here, and we've stumped on one right here. Armored personnel carriers have deployed. Nope, maybe they're not. So we lost both the carrier and the subunit, the infantry squad. The bombs appear. Let's see what we hit. Secondary explosions. Excellent. But what did we hit? Three tanks. But there's more tanks here, here, and here. Plus another one in the west. An improved conventional munitions strike catches the artillery. Well, that's what, as I stated earlier, that's their fault for being stupid. Holy cow, how much ICM does this guy have? He's using it all up. We can just thank our lucky stars that he didn't catch them. A whole stack of us. The armored personnel carriers, as suspected, are going to be decimated coming down this route. Hopefully they're deploying right now, so we're making the enemy spend more munitions. Yep, we're dying one at a time, which is okay. You got to die. This is the best way. Force him to shoot us 23 times to wipe it out. Unfortunately, this one hasn't deployed yet, so he got two for the price of one. Neither has this one deployed. So he's getting bonus score, I guess you could call it, if you were playing video games or pinball. He's caught in the open. The tank manages to engage. Or it gets engaged, but not manages to engage. This one tank is just ripping us apart without any return fire. They're just taking it and taking it and taking it. But with four infantry companies coming down, that's over 100 hits I'm hoping to force upon the enemy. Yep, just getting annihilated in the field. Not even a return shot anywhere. The visibility is 6,700 meters, and we see, and we will not shoot back. This is starting to look absolutely silly. There's the tank unit we missed before. Hello. Maybe someone will actually like to shoot back. It's only 1 kilometer away, and we will not return fire. Oh, that's the first shot actual tried to retaliate. Oh, great. So they're not dead. Only acting like they're dead. Yeah, this is we're going to enjoy killing this unit. How many has he killed? Holy cow. Must have killed at least an entire company worth of, 2 companies worth of vehicles. For nothing in return. Pathetic performance. Pathetic. Here are my orders. After reevaluating the attack and my air attacks and my approach, I see that I've got 2 companies have already been pretty much wiped out on the northern approach. There's only 4 here left. 2 armored personnel carriers and a mechanized rifle platoon, or rifle squad, are making their approach. So I've got about the equivalent of 2 companies making their final. The other 2 companies assigned to this objective are tied up on a minefield. We'll turn that off. The enemies dropped 3 minefields, 2 there and 1 here, which we haven't detected yet. But I saw the explosion going in, so I know it's been deployed. I saw the puff of smoke, I guess, when they fired it and deployed. So we know there's a minefield here. We just don't know how thick. I hope to God the enemy has used them all up, because they sure are a pain. They've tied up one of the tanks sitting on top of it and wiped out, well, not half, but a third. So we've got 2 of them. This is a prime artillery target for the enemy next turn. If he decides to waste it, he can either waste it on the trapped infantry, or he can try to hit some of the tanks that are running down his throat. Up to him. But we have the equivalent. This is a decimated battalion, or actually 2 battalions that were decimated on their approach. So we're down to about 50% strength here. Both of them should be able to make the objective. I don't know if we can hold it in the face of determined opposition with bombers and artillery the way they are. There's that anti-tank that we failed to wipe out. And here's this tank that's been just shooting the living daylights out of my units. This is the result of his handiwork alone. From this one tank has probably wiped out a company and a half, maybe even the entire 2 companies by himself. So he must die. I've reevaluated, and I'm no longer going to try to gather and assemble and resupply and refuel and go in. I'm sending the attack directly in. Notice how it takes me 30 minutes to get things moving, but hey, if I want to change my attack and go in a whole different way, it's instantaneous. I can move these and move them back, and boy, the orders are immediately taken. But if I want to get them moving, it takes 30 minute penalty, which makes this order process absolutely silly. But we're moving forward on this, so I think we'll capture the objective. We'll probably lose two more of these armored personnel carriers to this Milan or to this tank here, but the rest should be able to get through. As noted earlier, this one wasn't expected to survive. Look at the trail of bodies he left behind. He's done his job. We've already deployed here. We're on foot, so it will make it hopefully harder for the enemy to kill. But this is another prime artillery target. We're presenting the enemy hopefully with too many targets for him to serve. And I don't know how many artillery batteries, 3, 6, but he's got a lot of it. And he's fired a great number of ICM, those are improved conventional munitions rounds that ripped apart a number of tanks already on this. Let's take a look at that. That hit us here and took apart a couple of our companies, our also a number of them missed right behind. He doesn't have unlimited supplies of this kind of special munitions, so I really, really hope he's wasted a lot of them and has no more, or not many more. However, I've determined that this enemy tank platoon must die, so I've ordered a company to swing past and go right overrun on it. It's got four chieftains, and we will be taking no survivors. That's the specific order, no survivors from this one. I've also brought in my artillery. I'm going to hit this one. Each of my three artillery companies are going to hit, drop two stonks on right on top of it. That's a total of six. By the time this company, I'm really hoping this company will arrive afterwards so it doesn't get caught in the artillery. The third stonk is going to try and take out this final Milan launcher, armored personnel carrier and Milan team. Now, I could have taken him out first, but he's probably going to wipe this guy off anyway, and I want this one dead first. He's much more deadly than this guy has. I don't think he's fired. I don't think he's gotten a victim yet. So, unfortunately, we can take a look at the different... We know that the artillery should be arriving within 4 minutes, 4, 9, and 10 minutes afterwards, approximately. Four, seven, and ten. I've tried... The tank should be arriving at 13:33, which is almost an hour later. This is kind of silly. So when even though we move it, it recalculates and it says I'm going to arrive in one hex away in at 13:15 or later. Well, that's over 33 minutes away. That's just silly. I don't think that's true. So it's hard to coordinate when you don't get the right numbers. I'm just gambling. That's why I only put in two stonk from each artillery company, because I don't want to be running in under on the third one and getting hit by my own artillery. Had that happen, been there, done that, don't want that again. Instead of this company was going to gather, end up here, by keeping all my reference points or waypoints in motion, I can move him around now. See, I expect the enemy's going to try to mine these crossroads or hit him with ICM, whatever's left over. And for that reason, maybe I should tell him to do that. No, can't. So he's going to follow the road out to here. I'm going to try to avoid this road and these crossroads and come across and into the fields. It's more exposed, but I strongly suspect the enemy's going to try to stop me up here. My two furthest advanced tank companies, one's been hit. I think he ran over the mine or was hit by a mine attack. But they're going to skirt around and head over to the outside. I'm using the furthest advanced, and they're going to just advance right into the first line of defenses. I expect this whole area to be seeded thickly with enemy infantry and or tanks or whatever defense they have. So if they even survive this 1 kilometer gap, there's very little cover. It's only 30% cover. They're going to be hammered badly and take huge losses here. This is slightly more cover at 80% and 60%, but they've got to cross this, I don't know what you call it, this roadway into these fields. So if anything survives, they're just going to hold on by their teeth and keep the enemy occupied while the second echelon the rest of the first echelon arrives. But I expect him, if they drop a minefield here or here, he's going to be tying up my both of these tank companies, and they'll have to fight it out from that point. If they make it past here, I'll be very surprised. The other elements of my first echelon, instead of gathering here, we notice there's nothing out here. We're going to send them straight in. They're also going to avoid the road if possible, because it's right down the enemy down the throat, and it's just too obvious a target. So they're going to try to come through the fields see all the different approaches I have by sending units on every different approach. Yes, they're going to arrive at this choke point, and maybe a couple others, but the enemy's got to really be quite perceptive and guess quite far ahead. There's a lot of areas he could lay up minefields all the way across and definitely get me, but he's already laid three, and I don't know how many more he has, but he can't have that more unless he's really, really lucky with reloads. So I suspect maybe one, maybe two more. Let's hope not more than three more minefields appear. So by sending, I'm sending them under slightly more exposed approaches, but we're going to cross through here. I'm trying to avoid the victory point location itself because it, as stated earlier, it's a pretty obvious target. I can take it anytime afterwards with my second echelon or even with a headquarters unit if I must. But I need the combat elements to get in as far as I can. So I'm trying to push these forward, not too far forward. They just have to survive to get in here, hold on, draw fire, force the enemy back, exhaust his ammunition while the second echelon arrives. Here are the rest. Now remember from the previous turn I said that I had set a waypoint for 3 hours delay. Now my tank did stop here, which is good, and that gives him gave me at least a little bit of flexibility on how to assign my final waypoint. He's sitting here, he doesn't have to wait for that stupid 30-minute command cycle delay. Instead, I can just delete this first waypoint, the one with 180-minute delay, and he's going to start racing off like a bat out of hell for his waypoint. So he's going to take off immediately. No 30. He's right in with the second echelon. I've ordered the first one's going to probably be taking huge losses, so I've ordered this one, the second one, to go a little bit further to leapfrog over top of the bodies of their comrades. These first echelon I might have to pull them back. They might actually be going too far. Let's not do that. I'm trying to stay off the bullseye. Now, if I can get in here and hold this position, I can try to dominate, provide fire, make it deadly for the enemy to try to cross. But he's pretty well. I guess I'm going to have to go down a little bit further. In order to threaten him, he cannot, if he's trying to bring these tanks back in to reinforce, I don't want to give him a free one. My second, if I can hold this copse or this forest, these woods here, if I can get three companies of tanks, a battalion of tanks in here, I want to go across and capture this final victory point location, but I have to make the sprint or the crossing, not a sprint, but a crossing, and I'll approach from the wooded side with at least a little bit of coverage and protection, rather than heading down the road and getting shot to pieces from everything, from the flights on the other side and the woods and the fields here. So that's kind of what my follow-on strategy will be. We know he's got tanks and we know he's got infantry in the woods here, so that makes it an interesting proposition whether or not I can capture this last one. So I've got three companies coming in and they're trying to go through the woods and hold. This one's coming through a slightly exposed to the woods, to the fields a little bit more, but unless he's got something up high here, we've taken out his reconnaissance unit. I don't know if it was reconnaissance or maybe an anti-tank unit, but probably reconnaissance. So unless he's got something up here waiting for it, I'm going to have to take that risk. Other companies are following up. And we're sending in this, and the second echelon hasn't even moved yet. So I'm hoping that they don't have the orders bug and that they'll be moving right behind it. So there's a little bit of space between them and they can avoid the minefields. Double check to make sure that they aren't going to run through any of the mines and none of the paths lead in here. Once they get off the mines, we'll be sending them in through here. For my other tank company, this was the same one that had a waypoint delay of 3 hours put onto it. So I'm going to take this one out. I'm going to delete it. And now she's going to race in just like the first one. So if we are lucky and get past, here's the first echelon. Here's the first and a half echelon. And then maybe the second echelon will arrive further. I'm pushing the artillery up as far as possible, simply because if he's going to get hit, if the enemy's shooting at my artillery, he ain't shooting at my tanks. And I need the tanks more than I need the artillery. My Gecko platoon survivors are going to be heading back and forth. They're kind of rearmed and they kind of resupplied. They took a shot at the helicopter before he disappeared over here. So they're still providing a very, quite a valid, look at that. Look at the range of that SAM. So they're providing very valuable air coverage to keep the tornadoes off our backs. The other SAM, the one sole survivor, is going to be rearming and then coming back to hopefully provide support. As stated earlier, if he's shooting at my SAMs, he ain't shooting at my tanks. The headquarters companies are starting to leap forward. They're using the same technique I used earlier. We're going to put a huge delay afterwards on the second point. So they're going to come up here, hide behind this ridge. I've got three or four headquarters all coming through here, all hiding behind the ridge, and then trying to extend their command radius. Unfortunately, command radius only extends this far, and a lot of the tanks have already outrun them. So I've created ad hoc headquarters companies, and I've pretty much chained all my tanks together. See, here I've got one after another, after another, after another, after another. So I've got five links all in a row from tanks from the unit above them. I'm hoping that, in my belief, that as long as it's within command range of something, the unit will perform better. And if it drops into resupply, but I don't intend to resupply anything. But I do feel, I have a gut feeling only, it's not been proven empirically, that a unit within command range of at least another unit will shoot more often or receive orders or perform better. But once they're already in motion, so I don't have to worry about a 30-minute delay on these, and they seem to be working out well. I can't afford to lose any of the actual headquarters units because I have 16 orders right now, and if I start losing units, they're usually about two or three per wiped out headquarters unit. This will reduce the number from 16, 13, 10, and I need to be able to issue orders more than I need the paltry one tank or so that comes with every headquarters unit. The combat effectiveness of a headquarters unit is insignificant compared to its ability to generate orders. I'm sending my one helicopter unit is resupplied, and I'm sending it on quite a dangerous mission. At the end, when the bomb run went in last time on this hex and wiped out the three tanks on this hex, it noted that there's a tank platoon here, a tank platoon here, and it also detected this tank platoon and this tank platoon. Now, we can't see these, but I've brought I've got three airstrike missions, and I've brought three of them over to these two hidden ones, plus the one in the field. Now, the one in the field, it's in motion. They had a little red dot showing that it was still in motion last time. So I attacked this one, and I'm giving it a range of two. So hopefully I will catch him somewhere in here before he runs out. These other ones, the enemy, I think, has made a little error, unless he's trying to move through here. He's trapped himself in the forest, and because he's trapped himself in the forest, it's very slow moving for him. So unless he's at hasty speed, which would make him very exposed, he's not going to be able to get out here. So I'm going to try to ignore him. I'm trying to get at him with the aircraft by killing him in here. This one could actually come out around and be more mobile, but this one is stuck by forest hexes all the way around. So he's almost like gift wrapped for me to go after him with bombers. I'd go after this one with the bombers, but they take 15-minute delay before their strike mission goes in. It's 12:57. So the artillery will arrive and almost will be finished firing before the airstrike ever does. By judiciously and parsimoniously doling out my orders, I have only used up 6 out of 16, so I've got plenty. But I want to keep this practice simply because you never know when you run out of orders. Like sometimes when you have to move them all, we ran out of orders, and we don't want that to be happening too often. Here we go. The deadly Chieftain platoon keeps annihilating my tank company, my mechanized infantry. Very well done, very good shooting on his part. I'm going to enjoy his death. At point blank range, even his old guns are simply amazing in their accuracy. his helicopter stays out of the battle, and even though he doesn't want to risk it with the SAM around, that's good enough. I've neutralized him. So long as I keep him out of play, I'm happy. Even if I don't have to be killing him, I'd rather be killing him for certain, but if I keep him from responding and playing a role, I'll have to be satisfied. The first chieftain dies, thankfully. I hope he burns. He continues to take shots at my poor infantry. Thankfully, the losses were light. The turn executes. My artillery arrives over his chieftain platoon. Let's hope we can kill it. We can see he's trying to evade. That little black dot means he's on the move, and he's moving in the southwesterly direction. So hopefully he's gotten down to a very low level. He's trying to escape or evade, and we can catch him in a more exposed posture. He's in probably very exposed posture. Normally, if he's dug in, he's in hold, dug in posture, or if it's a hold here. But if he's trying a hasty move, he should be exposed. But our artillery is useless. And we tried to kill him, and we couldn't. He continues to butcher the infantry. His command unit here, looks like two Ferret command vehicles and two Chieftain tanks, are hammering me on the road, just decimating this infantry company. The infantry continue to take it and cannot respond. He's caught my tank company in the open on the road. We've managed to skirt it without hitting any mines. The mortars drop, but they're light mortars, so I'm hoping there won't be too much damage here. Oh, he got one. Damn it. But he's wasting his heavy artillery on going against my mortars. That's fine. My mortars weren't doing very much anyway, so the more he shoots at them, the less he shoots at a tank. A minefield is deployed in front of my infantry company. Improved conventional munitions, ICM, salvo, lands in an open field. Thank goodness. That would have wrought havoc had it hit one of my tank units. Another mine deploys on the road. He's trying to slow me down. That's a good job on his part. And one more mine appears right on the target. We'll have to keep track of them. My final artillery burst goes in over the self-propelled anti-tank unit. Nothing. My artillery gunners are sure lousy. The third and final salvo goes in. We've killed the Milan launcher. Good. The armored personnel carrier is not as effective as the anti-tank guided missile launcher. Even in flight, he manages to decimate the mechanized rifle company. Again, two more. Just hammering them. Looks like this tank isn't going to move for another hour. So we'll have to fix his reference points. He goes after the two trapped mechanized rifle companies in the road on top of the minefield with improved conventional munitions. Well, we didn't expect them to survive anyway. Now, my fault here is I left them in assault mode when they were trying to clear the minefield. I should have put them into hold mode, but I didn't want to suffer this 30-minute stupid delay in orders. So I tried to cheat and leave them in assault mode so that they would get off the minefield faster and then proceed on to their target. This is costing me because while they were in assault mode, they had a covered posture. It's not too bad, but it's still more exposed. Had I put them into a hold mode, I would have had suffered the 30-minute penalty, but at least they would have had dug-in posture and been able to survive the artillery a little bit better. That's my fault. Command decision error. They've caught my headquarters on top with an artillery burst. I don't know how he saw it, but he did it. Damn it. And now he's hammering it. I'm hoping... Oh, he didn't wipe it out, so I didn't lose any command links. He's hurt me badly with only one survivor, but he hasn't wiped us out. More mortars drop on my tank platoon. Tank company. My infantry company, caught in the fuel, continues to take losses. We jumped on the mines. We'll have to note where this anti-tank platoon went off, but he doesn't have any more launchers, so he's less effective. He only has a couple of armored personnel carriers, and their range is quite short. But this anti-tank platoon located here is very deadly. Look at all that. He's still got 9 units, and we've been dropping artillery on him all day long and unable to kill it. We've managed to kill 3 carriers and 1 infantry squad here. So 4 carriers and an infantry squad. Not bad. We've reached the first line of defense. Our bombers have found their tanks. Trapped deep in the woods. Three explosions means we've wiped out that tank platoon. And notice we've detected the other one. So he's still here, even though we can't see him, he's still there. So he will require another visit from the bombers and or artillery next turn. We've caught the command tank unit in the field. And she's wiped out. I certainly hope that impedes the enemy's ability to issue orders next turn. The last tank platoon is hit by air fencers. Notice he's trying to evade with the little red dot. He's heading in this direction. He's trying to get out, and we caught him. Wiped out. So only one left. Down south, we continue to take toll on the infantry platoons defending. 2 more armored personnel carriers are destroyed. The enemy drops artillery into an open field. Thank goodness. He's churning the roadways, but we're already past it. Sadly, the motorized rifle companies are going to get hammered again. Butchered. They're down to 25% on the other company. This one's going to be probably down to about 30%. Yeah, about 30% level. 25% level now. See, he's wiping out both the carrier and the subunit sitting inside it. Really bad decision on my part. But it's nice to see the ICM didn't hit anything. The company trapped on the minefield continues to take losses from the anti-tank guided missile unit. Another armored personnel carrier dies. The tank company punishes the armored personnel, the infantry, the mechanized infantry. This one keeps popping up, launching, and then disappearing. Too many decisions to be made. Do we kill this one first, the tank first, or the infantry down here, or the one up here? So many decisions to be made. And there's still one more anti-tank launcher up, or at least the armored personnel carriers may not be anti-tank launcher. We lose another vehicle to this damn anti-tank unit. Even though we knew it was here, we could not kill it, no matter how much artillery we put on there. There goes that launcher again. We jump on the mines and detonate one, two, lose three tanks to these stupid mines, even though we saw it was there. Couldn't help it. Let's hope that no other unit decides to be that stupid and jump on the minefield. As stated earlier, it's a pretty obvious target. We continue to lose vehicles in the minefield to this wretched anti-tank guided missile unit. The second tank company enters the defenses and goes into hold. I won't make that mistake again. Next turn, we'll put this one in a hold position until the minefield is cleared. We'll suffer the 30-minute penalty if we have to. Another mechanized infantry platoon is hit, with the armored personnel carrier dying. Here comes that helicopter. Here's the situation as of 1307 hours. In the south, we're fairly quiet. He hasn't made any approaches, and I haven't done anything to approach this area. But we know there's still enemy units here, infantry units, and possibly a surviving tank unit. Possibly. Can't tell from all the shell holes, so we've lost track of them. We've broken into the center, but our tanks here are low on ammo. They're holding on and forcing the enemy to fight it out, shoot back at us, but we're not doing very much to kill them. In the north, my mechanized rifle company is still trying to close on the objective. We've been taking shots from this location, from an anti-tank guided missile launcher, probably a Spartan, a mobile launcher. He's been taking shots ineffectively, but he's still taking shots, so I want him taken out. Everything here is now on foot. We're just making our final approach where we've been hit hard. The morale is low. Ammo is low. Readiness is low. Ammo is high because we don't shoot at anything. But we do have overwhelming numbers. I'm hoping to get close enough so we can actually take this position. My two companies that were set to reinforce it have been almost wiped out. Now, what I've done is these will be approaching, and if they hold it, they hold it. But there still was an anti-tank launcher here. Plus, I suspect there's another tank platoon up here. I don't think we killed it. As well, there were one or two armored personnel carriers, the FV-432s, that were part of the anti-tank platoon. Now, we've killed the anti-tank gunners themselves, but the two armored personnel carriers, they still have some armament. They could pose a threat. They could drive off a weakened, we had almost two battalions worth of motorized riflemen approaching, and now there's probably, scraped together, there might be half a battalion, two companies. That's all that survived. So they could drive us off this objective if that happened. So what I've done is I've ordered the helicopters. I'm going to take a sweep up through here. Maybe we'll knock out this anti-tank unit platoon on the way through up, and then we're going to overfly it on the way back, and maybe we'll get some shots in on this one as well before flying off to resupply. We'll go off here to resupply. Hopefully he won't catch us on the ground. That's just hope, blind hope. He'll be too busy trying to shoot everything else. My other helicopter is going to be doing another assault run, and we're doing the same thing. We're flying in. If his location is here, we're gonna overfly it by flying all over it. A couple of places here and here, where we can actually exchange fire with him, and maybe we can take him out before returning to rearm. I brought the artillery in, but I'm going to center it on the one in the village, which has been butchering these approaching mechanized rifles. There's almost nothing left of these guys, but they're holding on, they're drawing fire, and they're forcing the enemy to fight. We haven't seen anything behind it. Here comes that helicopter. Maybe he's trying to blast a way open or a few of these. I've got my SAM launcher moving back across here. We're going to go up over this ridge, and at this point, I think we should be able to bring him under fire. We need another shot. Maybe we can kill the damn thing once and for all. My other surviving SAM launcher is under resupply right now, so he won't be back for a while. Probably won't be back for another hour. Do we have another hour? Yeah, we got plenty of time. Plenty of time. My SAM launcher in SA-17 here, SA-13, is still hiding back here, but we'll probably be moving him up very quickly. Unfortunately, I had tanks moving in, and one of the lucky things is this tank never hit the final waypoint yet, so I'm going to redirect him so he's not stopped. We don't have to suffer a 30-minute penalty for stopping, and we just immediately redirect him without any penalty into the fire zone. So he's going to come try to take one of these victory points. The air strike, we're bringing in the airstrike. I only have one available right now. I'm bringing it. I'm hunting this tank. Well, the reason I'm hunting this tank is currently our situation is I've inflicted 5,900 points of damage on him. He only has, this is approximately 64, almost 65% damage. So we're looking at inflicting another 470 points of damage, then we'll put him into sudden death and win the game that way. So his tank is worth about 100 points. If I can kill it, that's just 370 to go. I'm wasting the entire airstrike on him. There's not much ammo left in it, but there's enough that, because I don't know where he's run, the airstrike is a better option than artillery, because the airstrike has I assigned it a range of 1, so it'll shoot all the way around here. I should be able to catch that tank. Now, killing it's another matter, but I sure hope we can catch it. In the south, we're just going to duke it out. I'm ordering my tanks in to try and capture these woods or dominate these woods. So we'll have tanks here, here, and here if I can arrange it. I'm also arranging for later on, I'm going to try to do an overrun attack right over these guys. There's 2 and 5. There's a lot of infantry here. So I've got to be lucky if I can survive and put an overrun this one and right onto this one. Now, tanks-wise, I don't think the tank overrun works very well. Well, it's not very effective in the game. It doesn't kill them. More often than not, these stupid infantry units will be able to kill the tank. So that's what I'm thinking is going to happen, but hey, it's only a game. Let's try it. They should be running for their lives once the tank enters, but hey, who knows? It's a tank company. There's only 13 tanks. They're only foot soldiers, but they're going to fight like Audie Murphy right to the end. Now, I'm not going to make the same mistake I made before. This tank is trapped on the minefield, sweeping it. So I ordered it into hold position. Even though it could be moving on, I'd rather take the 30-minute penalty than have it wiped out in an exposed posture. I've done the same with my mechanized rifle companies in the north. They've stomped on the mines, and they're now in dug-in posture. So if and when the enemy brings his artillery, which I think he will, they'll at least have a better chance of survival. Not a good one, but better. My late arriving tank companies, I'm going to order them around. We have three of them here, and I'm going to order them to take separate routes. Notice how I'm taking one route here and taking another route here. So they're going to go around, overrun, and try to go for that last objective. But they're taking two separate routes so we're going to overrun this one, and the other one's going to overrun this one. Hopefully something will survive for us to get to the objective. Artillery is resupplying right now, and here's another tank company. I've got to decide where I want to do. See, notice by keeping all the in waypoints in play and using it at the end rather than burning them up early on, I can now redirect where I want rather as opposed to where I have to. I've ordered her to support the attack here and head on in deep. Now, I hope I haven't had too many tanks on here. They're overstacked and then leaving them more vulnerable, but I probably will be losing a lot of them as they go through. So if with a little luck, I can switch over. There's a whole bunch of tanks coming in. You can see by the deep pink lines, there's a lot of tanks ending up in here or right on top of the objective. Hopefully not too many and to be hammered by enemy artillery. I can't explain the couple of our tank companies that just stopped dead in the middle of the field for no apparent reason. They didn't take fire, that nothing. They had their orders and they've just stopped dead. So I'm glad I've been parsimonious with my orders allocation. I'll be able to send them in on the attack. In the middle, I had two headquarters platoons sitting here, headquarters sections, I guess, not platoons. We're sitting here when they got hit by artillery fire. They were almost wiped out, but not quite. So long as they survive, they get to generate orders, and I didn't suffer any of the... I still have the 16 with which I started the game. However, my decision is headquarters are just too valuable. It's only one tank and one armored personnel carrier, and this one has only one tank left over. So that's two tanks and an armored personnel carrier. That's not very much combat power, but their ability to generate orders is more important than the combat power they possess. So, because I still have the waypoints, remember, this was the waypoint where we entered a long delay on the 180-minute delay. So I still have the luxury of redirecting the waypoint. What I'm going to do, I'm pulling them back, even though I could use them up front for command control. I'm going to delete the waypoint. So now this is going to be like an instantaneous move. Bam! We don't have to wait for some stupid 30 minutes in order for the orders to filter down. We're going now. And I'd rather pull them back and keep generating those extra orders than to have them destroyed, possibly destroyed. I don't even know how the enemy saw me. It must have been from the... If we take a look at Control L, we can see up here, so he probably saw me from the same range. So I'm going to pull them back to... Heck, we might as well pull them right back to the start line, rather than risk their destruction. Do the same here. This has the waypoint of 180 delay. Now I'm going to cancel it and take off like a rocket. I have one more headquarters come. It wasn't hit before. I don't think he can see it. We'll check Control L. He might have seen it. He might not have seen it. So I'll take my chance that he hasn't detected this one yet. So I'll wait for a little while longer until I'm under attack. Here's the real stupid part of this situation. Notice all these tanks up here? I've got an entire battalion's worth of tanks that haven't moved an inch because of the stupid orders delay or whatever bug happens on here. This happens to this. They either didn't get it or aren't going to follow it. Whatever reason, they didn't move, and that's a third, maybe even half of my remaining combat power stuck up here because they couldn't figure out their orders. So we're going to redirect them into the combat zone by... I'm going to hopefully take out, reassign them their waypoints, and then delete the earliest waypoint. Maybe that'll give them enough oomph so that they can race down here and support the attack, because right now they're useless and I don't want to wait another 30 minutes for nothing to happen. Here are my final orders. Even using up a lot of them, I'm still sure I still have two extras left over, so that's because I've been saving them for such a long time, and well, most will call me anal about it. I've got the tanks moving. We're going to try to make this approach to the south and try to get that last victory point here. I've got them both moving that were previously stopped, so within the next 30 minutes, I'll see how these tanks are going, and I'll probably be repositioning them afterwards because I'll know whether or not this attack goes in or is going to be bogged down and need support. I have taken, retasked these. I've had to waste one of my waypoints and deleted it. Hopefully by deleting one, the second one will kick in and these tanks will start moving right away. But they're my second echelon, so I'm driving them deep for the final victory points. I'll keep my headquarters in the back, and I even started to move my reconnaissance units. I'm going to move this one up onto this ridge. Maybe he can spot for this area. Maybe he can find that extra tank or give warning of that extra tank. But I don't need to save him anymore because he's now in the rear. This other two reconnaissance units, we're going to go out here to see if we can see what, check out what's happening here. Before then, I can decide if I want to send my tanks up this way or down, which one's an easier objective to capture. Also going to move my surface-to-air missile platoon up. He's got pretty good coverage here, but now this is where the action is, and this, here we go. We actually got a shot off at the helicopter. Excellent. He's making his move. Maybe we can get him. But his infantry, as I worried about earlier, is going to start hammering on my tanks. Some useless 5-point unit is taking out a 70-point tank. We found the tank. Maybe we can shoot it on en passant. My ability to kill infantry is just worthless. The anti-tank unit continues to smash my motorized rifle. Helicopters flew right past him, identified him, and wouldn't fire a shot. We're pouring fire into these units and unable to kill them. We did manage to kill another infantry unit, one at a time. Let's see how many tanks he kills before we actually wipe him out. Here comes the Artie. With this many spotters around, I'm hoping that the artillery will take a huge toll on him. Nothing! This is pretty depressing. Not three barrages and nothing. And he still fights back. Where do they get these supermen? Another launch from up here, somewhere, but we didn't see it. What an absolutely horrible turn. Horrible. We exchanged fire with the infantry teams. In the north, my mechanized rifle company loses another SAM team. But that's okay. He can't reach the helicopter anyway. He's not coming in close. We have a couple of armored anti-tank guided missile launches, and the artillery arrives over the anti-tank platoon. No result. This is just getting incredibly silly now. Surrounded on three sides and being pounded by artillery, and he still takes no loss. Oh, finally, a secondary explosion. A lousy command car. I wonder how many tanks I'm going to lose before this infantry company dies. That's three already from just soldiers. The helicopter flies past and engages but doesn't kill anything. But we have detected another self-propelled anti-tank unit here. The anti-tank unit finally retreats out of the woods. We'll know he's here and keep a track of him. That's where the RT comes next turn. The enemy brings his smoke. He's trying to cover it. Well, okay. I wonder if it might have been better off trying to hit it with heavy high explosive rather than smoke. But he catches two companies right on the same hex. That's great shooting, or just great luck. But that was mortar, so it was quite light and not much damage, no damage sustained. The trapped mechanized rifle, mechanized infantry company takes another hit. More mortars. And the heavy stuff falls on the tanks. Even though he might not have heavy weapons, he can call in the heavy artillery. And the enemy's got plenty of that. Here comes the improved conventional munitions. And my company's in exposed posture trying to resupply. Quite deadly. Half, 50% more knocked out. This company is going to be combat incapable. It's listed as a headquarters company, so I'm going to have to move the subunits out of it before it gets wiped out, in order so I don't suffer the command penalty, I think. Here comes more improved conventional munitions. Deadly, deadly. Another headquarters company. This is all my chained together in command links. We saw him leave, but we were unable to shift the artillery onto his new hex. That's too bad. Such a waste. And this anti-tank unit has not been molested whatsoever. So he's fully intact and probably can still kill off my surviving infantry unit. There's only one squad left, the 30mm grenade launcher unit. It's a GL, I think. Even in the open, we don't seem to be able to kill him. Notice, even with only 30% concealment, he's two hexes away and I still can't see him. That's incredible. Just incredible. Here he is, and we know he's there, and we can't see him. Oh, we've got him on top of a tank. Let's see if maybe we can kill this one. More arty arrives over top my leading tank company. They're really being punished. His arty seems to have no problem killing mine. Mine can't seem to hit the broadside of a barn. Here come more improved conventional munitions. Wow. I wonder if there's going to be enough scraps left over to put in a single coffin. Only one more to go. Brutalized, as expected. And we can't overrun them. Incredible. And there's one tank running in highly exposed posture, and we cannot kill it. Light mortars are falling, but they're still enough to knock the treads off. Looks like he can easily disable them, and that's taking them out of the game. So I still have to worry about the mortars. Thank goodness they have no effect. Come on, now I'm saying a prayer. Kill him. Kill him. Nothing. Incredible. We've just flown right over top of him and failed to engage. Incredible. The commissars will take care of your family tonight, sir. We bring the artillery. Oh, the airstrike comes in. Finally. That's another 100 points to my credit. But we look at all this infantry here, hidden among the wheat fields. They die damned hard. More mortars drop. The British sure have a lot of mortars. They have a lot of heavy artillery, too. There goes a tank from a stupid mortar strike. By the sound of the video of the audio replay, this sounds like more heavy artillery coming down on my hapless infantry. Smashed flat in the field. Looks like my last tank is going to finally eat it. Let's hope it doesn't punish my command cycle too badly. I need to move the subordinate units out as fast as I can. Ooh, he's wasting improved conventional munitions on a mechanized infantry unit. Well, bad for them, but at least he's not using it on one of my tanks. Someone's got to bite it. Better be the infantry. Two companies virtually wiped out. Oh, great. But we do have some SAMs left. Is it enough? Nope, we didn't fight them off. So he's starting to use his tornadoes aggressively, which is excellent. I'm in a hold position, at least I was in a hold position, so that it has a dug-in posture, so it gives me a little bit more protection, even though I'm on the open road. Dug-in is better than exposed or even covered posture, or it's not better than covered posture, but at least it wasn't exposed posture. Look at all the hits I'm taking, and that was in hold, in dug-in posture, and I'm decimated by 50%, by one airstrike. Actually, that's 60%, close to 60% destruction. Wow. Shit. Wow. At least he didn't take out the double stack. We're trying to overrun him, and we just can't do it. There we go. First one's in. How many tanks will we lose out of this 10? In the company. My last surviving tank is doing the headless chicken dance and running away. Yep, they must be rolling hand grenades into the gun barrels to be this effective against tanks. Let's see if the enemy has enough guts to bomb his own troops next turn. He's got three or four of my tank companies piled up here. Will he bomb to take them out? I would. He's taking out 60-70 point tanks for losing a couple of lousy 5 or 10 point infantry platoons or infantry squads. That's a bargain. I would annihilate this hex with improved conventions and high explosive next turn, if I had an option. Look at more infantry all over the place. You just can't kill these cockroaches. Situation report at 1330 hours. My attack is going well through the center, and I've penetrated his first line of defense. I've captured the 3,000 point victory location, and we'll check the staff summary right now. So we right now have approximately 80% of our forces, and we've knocked the enemy down to approximately at 6142. He started off with 9134, so he's just under 70%. 69% losses. So once the game hits 37. Once he takes 70% losses, we enter a sudden death, sudden death goal line, and the game can end at that point. I think we're going to play to that point, so I'm going for the win quickly. My tank, they're all spotted, but we're still moving forward, and we're still trying to occupy this forest hex. Now that we're spread out a little bit, the enemy won't be able to catch them all in the same hex with artillery, which is, unfortunately, this is where they all are. If I was him, I'd bomb the hell out of this thing and catch all my tanks at the same shot. But let's see if he's got the balls to try that. I'm trying to spread them out, separate them near the end into different hexes, but right now they've gotten bunched up here and we just can't separate them. I'm trying to overrun this unit, but there's a lot of infantry here, and they're, as you can probably see from this video, they're damned hard to kill, like cockroaches. You just can't step on all of them. and I can't hit him with artillery. I'm going to bring artillery in, but I'm only going to fire one salvo at this one before I shift fire somewhere else, because this advancing tank unit, if I try to hit it with more than one salvo, I might very well run into it. Heck, I might even do it right now, but I'm gambling that I can get my salvo off, get an artillery strike in from each of my units within range are going to strike. Then I'm going to try to strike at this one who's fleeing. He's probably going to run out of here by next turn. So I'm going, let's see if we can't catch him maybe on the outside. And then for the anti-tank guided missile unit up here, who is hidden, but he's still firing missiles at us sporadically. So we've got one strike in here, second strike here. Let's see if maybe we can catch him before he leaves. He's got three Milan launchers, and those are still potent weapons if he can get them rearmed. He's in hasty headless chicken syndrome, headless chicken mode right now, so he's running around like crazy. My units, my depleted infantry units, were doing the same. They were in headless, they were doing the headless chicken with such low morale, they were about to do a hasty move out of here and run. But I ordered them back to hold positions, even with low ammunition, low morale, and low readiness. I'm hoping that they'll stay. This forces the enemy. I want the enemy to waste his artillery destroying them, because if he's shooting at these things, he's not shooting at these things. So I want to give him a target. I want him too many targets to serve. Meanwhile, these my units here can recover a little bit, but I don't dare go into resupply mode, because this one unit will force them to do a headless chicken dance and run off the target, and I don't want that. Got a helicopter coming through, rearmed. We're going to try to sweep through here. We're on an assault mission, so we're going to overfly all of it, force in there, then out, see if we can't flush some more game. My tanks still haven't moved yet, so they're starting to come through now. I still have three reference points with which to move them, so I've allocated them for very distant. We're going to try to go after this last one, because my forward tanks, my first echelon, will be pretty much spent in trying to resupply, or else just holding on for their dear life, just like these tanks are here. They're in resupply mode. They did their headless chicken dance, got chased out of here by the enemy infantry, and now this one's going to be chased out of here. There's enemy infantry stacked up underneath it. This one was chased out, so hopefully he'll be able to resupply and re-enter the fray, but it's only one tank. He didn't shell my tank trapped on the minefield, so I'm going to take a chance. I'm going to try to resupply him. He's only at half 40% ammo and readiness, so I pretty much do need to resupply. It's a risk, but I'm going to have to take it. This tank is acting as the linchpin between my headquarters and my forward elements. He's only five tanks left, so I hope he doesn't get wiped out. He is currently sitting on top of, a copse of trees, so the protection isn't great, but it's still 70% coverage, so it's not perfect, but it's better than nothing. He's in hold, and he got bombed, so he lost eight tanks in one shot. That's two-thirds of his fighting strength. Still up with ammo and readiness, so I'm going to have him hold here and try to protect anything that might be coming up this way. He's acting mainly as a communications link. Here come my advancing companies. This one is acting as... he's linked to here, he's linked to here, he's linked to here. So these are all in communications with each other, and we've reorganized them into Kampfgruppen. Here are three, it's another, but over a battalion of tanks worth coming through. That's almost two battalions. Here's three battalions of tanks still heading in. They're the second echelon heading for distant targets. We're going for that long bomb. My helicopter is resupplying. My SAM got a shot off on him. Of course, we missed. And now we're going to move over here into the open ground. Maybe we'll get another shot at him from outside. My headquarters are all holding back and rearming the ones that were damaged. I just can't afford... I'm quite amazed that I'm this late into the game, and I still have 16. All 16 of my orders are permitted. I haven't lost any headquarters yet. I like the flexibility, and I'm quite anal about it, but it seems to be paying off. I've used up 13 of my 16. I'm moving my SAM up forward to give these a little bit more protection, because they're just moving outside of range. So I got to keep that tornado threatened, even though the SA8 does a good job of it. They weren't able to protect this one sufficiently, and they got off a big bombing raid. So let's try to get them up higher. My companies trapped on the minefields have cleared the minefield, but they're in such poor shape right now, such low readiness and morale, I've got to resupply them in order to bring them forward. They may be the ones that actually decide the possession of this unit, this location, at the end, because if he hits it with artillery, he could theoretically wipe out most of this over here, and then it'll be a contest between some anti-tank unit and another anti-tank platoon down here. So I'm not moving them forward. I'm even assigning the reconnaissance units to move up forward to take a look around here. May actually engage in some hand-to-hand combat. I've got my airstrikes coming in. I've got two available right now, and I'm bringing them right on top. This is the last known position of the tank. I think we killed one of them, but if I can kill two more, we can shove them into the sudden death zone, and I think we'll call it a game at that point. As we notice, just to show that all my order of battle, every tank, every unit I can is linked to another unit, so that we are all within command range of another. Every unit is within command range of another, so that when we resupply, hopefully we'll get maximum effect on these. These are the reds here. It's a nice function. When it shows up in red, it shows that there's something wrong here, and we can see it. It's either low morale, low ammo, low readiness, whatever. But it's also out of command range. So it's a quick check to make sure that everything's within command range before we continue our turn. All these lines make it kind of hard to see, and I can make out, and I agree. Even playing it, it's hard to know which one goes where, and there's no way really to find back which one is coming from which unit heading in which direction. And that is a limitation of the game. Wish it was a little bit clearer, so I'll turn it off so that we'll only show one at a time to hopefully clear up the screen. Here we go. The infantry and the armor trade shots, and we cannot kill them. Just run over them, guys. Oh, we got a shot off to kill an infantry squad. We're desperately trying to kill this anti-tank platoon with not much luck. There goes another tank. Must roll over a grenade. We do take a toll in the infantry, but only at point-blank range. More fire is detected from this hex. We don't even know what's there, but it's incoming. He's on the move. Let's see. Did we kill him while he was in motion and kill the subunits underneath? No. We're dispersed now. The minefield is cleared underneath. Where's that arty? There goes, he's escaped, as suspected. So I've got a little bit of artillery coming down on him, even though the first two salvos are going to miss. I don't think the artillery is going to shift the fire, unfortunately. Here comes that first stonk. Got him. It's not insufficient. He's just got too much infantry here to kill. Another squad, one at a time. And the crunchies are down. The enemy displaces. Now he's got a free shot at this hex. I actually have to get on top of this hex soon, or else he's going to have a... Oh, there. Excellent. At least it'll give the enemy pause, hopefully, from destroying his own units. But if he's got this... If he's as good as I think Goobie is, a player, he's going to nuke this hex just to get at my tanks. My tanks are worth a heck of a lot more than his infantry. Here comes that anti-tank guided missile unit. We kill another AP armored personnel carrier, and this looks like a scout unit running. When he starts running, he's in hasty mode, and we should be able to shoot him in the back, easily. We got one of them. There goes an anti-tank guided missile. Killing one of his... Ooh, doing well. Slaughter this unit. One command unit and two armored personnel carriers. Well done. And if we didn't notice, here, this little blue dot, that's where his tank has shown up. Hopefully he'll stay there long enough for my airstrike to arrive. And it looks like this might be the final turn. My tanks are overrunning his mechanized infantry platoon. Thank goodness. In the north, we detect another anti-tank platoon or section, and we're taking it under fire. His escaped infantry, anti-tank infantry squad is about here, and we're hitting him, and we're getting a couple of explosions. Excellent. You can run, but you can't you can't hide from Mr. Artie. I think this has finally wiped out that artillery unit. So it wasn't a total waste. In the open, we can do something about them, but in the fields and in the city, wow, digging them out is just like digging out lice. All the while, these lice get to bite back and kill me. 60-ton monsters, and they can still kill me. His tank tries to intercede and opens fire on my tanks, but he doesn't get any hits yet. We kill another infantry squad. Quite happy to do so. And we wipe out his last scout, Scorpion. We've even taken a pot shot at his helicopter. No luck. Here comes the RT. Oh my goodness, he's still got improved conventional munitions. But I'm glad he's wasting it on infantry when, in my opinion, would have been better spent against something like this. Heavy armor. But, hey, better them than us. If someone's got to die, let the infantry soak it up. Ah, there he goes. He made the right decision. Good for him. Calling it in on his own troops. Man's got balls. He is truly to be commended for putting victory in front of his troops. Good job. I'm glad it's just electronic troops and not real people. And I'd hate to be on his side, but he did the right thing. Yeah, take out those tanks. Hit them. Wow. See, if he had saved that barrage down here, he could have probably obliterated both of these tank companies. And his troops aren't even affected by it. That's the galling thing of it. He's hammering my tanks, and his troops are rolling through unaffected. My third and final barrage lands on the anti-tank guided missile company. We do get some explosions, but they're just not worth the same thing as a tank. They're, what, maybe 10 victory points at the most. Some satisfying secondary explosions, but he's still alive. What a pain. We're at the river, and we spot enemy infantry on the other side. We immediately take losses. But we go into hold posture, and that's dug in. So we can slug it out with them. But digging out infantry, I'm lucky we killed the infantry and the carrier at the same time. Digging them out, individual infantry squads, is nearly impossible. We picked up three armored personnel carrier, and there's five artillery pieces here. So it looks like they've got some... This is a mortar squad. Oh, boy. Holy cow. We just can't get off this darned infantry squad. He's tied us up. So he's murdering the infantry. He looks like an entire company of tanks has been wiped out in general. look at that. Nothing for his infantry. Nothing. He's had two lousy infantry squads, maybe one, and they just keep on killing me. Impressive. We'll have to keep track of where this artillery has run off to. Looking at all the damage, death, and destruction he's wrought upon these two tank companies, gotta wonder, if he had caught them out here earlier, I might not have an attack. He might have pinched off my spearhead entirely. We've killed the last two tanks. Excellent. Now we spotted more targets around it. He keeps bringing the arty onto us. Holy cow! That's a lot of ICM. I don't gotta wonder just how many he's been saving. Brutal! Just brutal! They don't call it Hell's Crossroad for nothing. Oh, we finally, after, what, there's almost 20, over 20 tanks destroyed, we finally kill his one lousy infantry squad. Incredible. His airstrike comes in. And we scared it off with our SAMs. So even though we don't shoot it down, we drive off the attack. We force him to evade. And we're brushing back the helicopter. Just like a pitcher does a batter crowding the plate, we brush him off. Push him back, even though we don't have to kill him. We just have to make him, threaten him, so that he backs off. Here comes another four infantry just sitting there tying up everyone as he just sucks it in. Now he's starting to stack up my tanks. Looks like another prime target for his ICM if he has any more left. That bastard. Wow, look at them all stacked up like cordwood here. And we couldn't get at them. We just can't kill them fast enough. My opponent has informed me that he has reached the 30% sudden death level and he would like to surrender and quit. We've had a great game. Even though the score may not reflect it, we are now at 70% or so tactical success. I'm just going to resign it now and congratulate my opponent for fighting hard. It was well done. He did a lot of great things this scenario. He used his artillery probing for my tanks. He forced me to deliver my attack early. I would like to have degraded his units a little further, but because he was starting to hit units that were in hiding, I was afraid he was going to start bombing the hell out of everything. His SAM hunting was excellent. He managed to snuff out most of them, but I had kept just a bare sliver enough alive so that the enemy had to commit his aircraft early, and we managed to drive them off. I don't know. Let's see if we shot any down. No, we never shot down his aircraft, but we prevented a major attack. He was about to bomb the hell out of one of my tank companies, or maybe two of them. They were stacked up. But the SAMs showed up just in time to fire a couple at him and scare him off. Well, that's better than nothing. So, well done. And he's making his attack on one of the victory point locations here. So, we're going to resign now. We'll check the final score. The victory point, nothing changes on these victory point locations. Looks like here, this victory point location will pass to my control, and this victory point location as well. So will this one. Now, reading these, it says 23 NATO point units with 122 subunits are within range. Effective range of influence is 975, and I have 999 units within range. Effective influence is 3345. So I guess this mass of tanks, somehow it exerts some influence over a certain range. I don't know what it is. I find this a little misleading. The game just awards these points. I can understand maybe the ones that are really, really close and are just about to pounce upon them. And I could see control changing hands, but these are a little bit more distant. For me to go after them, if the enemy has a number of artillery, and we saw how effective his improved conventional munitions, ICM rounds were, he annihilated. I've got one tank out of, I think, 23 tanks here. I have one tank survivor. So I find it just slightly misleading that maybe it gives a little bit too much control, gives a little bit too much something that I can actually get out there. Yeah, maybe one or two hexes, maybe. I can understand it having it, there's some kind of influence, but this is quite distant. Let's see how many. So I have a tactical success. We can see by his deployment, he's still got significant forces in the south. I mean, that could they have stopped us? Maybe not, but these are infantry platoons, and as we've seen over in the city, once they dig in, it's like trying to dig out a badger. It's really, really painful and expensive to do so. And he eats up my tanks. Even at short range, the mechanized rifle companies are able to kill tanks. So these mechanized rifle companies are worth a whole lot, 10 points or 12, 10 or 12 points. Yet he kills 50-point, 70-point tanks. And that's why I think maybe it's a little bit too much. I'm not really in favor of it, but it's part of the game, and that's what it allows. So, wow, look at that artillery park back here. Look at how much artillery he has. Let's check him out and see that he's got, holy dear Lord, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 155, I think these are, yes, 155 millimeter. They can fire scattering mines, they can go rocket assist, they can ICM. Look at all that he can fire. No wonder he was ripping me apart. I'm amazed that he didn't stack me up like cordwood in here with more mines than I could deal with and then blast the living daylights out of me. So I'm a tactical victory. I'm considering I got myself off lucky. Well done. I'm impressed. The score may not reflect it, but I am impressed with his defense. He did a lot of good things well. He kept me guessing around here. I kept him guessing. He pressed up. He took out my picket line. He tried to dominate the center. He still has forces in the north, which could sweep down had they been in the south. His anti-tank, it just ripped apart. This is not even a single tank mechanized rifle company survivor out of two battalions. I don't have enough to even call a motorized rifle company. That's about half. Well, with these, maybe there's one entire motorized rifle company out of two battalions. He just decimated me. So that was well done. He probed for my headquarters units. He took them under attack. Had he wiped out a few more, I'm just amazed that I still have 16. I was very, very careful to protect them, but a little bit more and he would have started knocking out command links, and that would have reduced the number of orders I could give to my tanks and slowed me down. The enemy, let's see how many he had. He was able to still issue 12 orders, so he still had pretty good control of his units. This concludes Hell's Crossroad against Goobie Goo for Flashpoint Campaigns.